This is the Buzz Adams Morning Show podcast. Barstool talk daily. Except it's really early in the morning and no booze. For the most part.
Sunny El Paso, Texas.
Yeah, baby!
The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
Man, is this gonna rock or what?
Thank you so much. Good morning and welcome to the show. For this Friday morning, it's the Buzz Adams Morning Show. We welcome you and we all together welcome Labor Day weekend into our lives. Hopefully a three-day weekend for most of our listening audience. I hope so anyway.
Yeah.
You know, of course, emergency personnel have to work here.
Sure.
Police officers, firefighters.
Important to people.
Convenience store clerks.
Yeah. Heroes, unsung heroes.
The essentials, yeah. I'm going to get to the weather because we have a flood alert for El Paso today.
What?
Yeah, there's a flood alert for El Paso. So let's do the golfer's forecast brought to you by Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. You can set up all your tee times online at painteddunes.com. Expecting some pretty heavy-duty thunderstorms today. So let me tell you the weather alerts. Flood advisory in effect for El Paso County until 11 o'clock tonight. Flood advisory also for Dinah-Ana County. Chance of some heavy rainfall, so we do have some thunderstorm alerts coming up. We'll keep on top of that, though, but just looking at the forecast here, it looks like the biggest part of the rain is going to be in the afternoon, so sometime afternoon, maybe 1 or 2 o'clock, El Paso is going to get, they believe, some pretty substantial thunderstorms today. 90 for the high temperature. And Joanna, I don't know if this is a sign of fall. 80s for the weekend.
Whoa! It's going to get chilly.
For all the Labor Day weekend. Yeah, get those sweaters. Unpack those sweaters and scarves.
Sweater weather.
Partly cloudy on Saturday. Still a chance of rain. Not as much as today with the advisories and so forth. But there is a 20% chance of rain for Saturday. 87 for the high tomorrow. A little bit of a chance of rain, and put it about 15% for Sunday, partly cloudy. Get this, 84 for the high temperature Sunday,
wow.
84 for the high temperature Labor Day Monday. So maybe some relief from the heat. The Golfer's Forecast is brought to you by Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. You can set up all your tee times and reservations online at painteddunes.com. That's painteddunes.com. Or call the Pro Shop. Their number is 915-821-2122 for Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. Good morning, Joanna Barba.
Oh, good morning to you, Buzz Adams.
Are you getting Monday off?
Yes.
Oh, good, because I would have felt like a real heel if I went on and then you had to work on Monday.
And I had to be
It would have been awful. Any plans for the Labor Day, or are you going to chillax?
I'm going to chillax, probably hit up a Kermes, a spirit store.
There's one in the mall on this side of town, on the west side.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
I picked up my daughter at 2:30 because she had early release. Because she's a senior.
What is with these kids and early release?
She gets early release because she was trying to explain it to me. It was very complicated. You know, when you were in high school, right?
Did you kind of tune her out?
You had I was doing my best, but I just couldn't grasp what she was saying. In high school, you had the same classes every day, right?
Yeah.
I guess, and she goes to Coronado.
Okay.
I guess they've got staggered days like college. So you might have three classes Monday, and you might have five classes on Tuesday. Anyway, she's out early, but she has to go back at 4:30 for theater. So we had a couple hours to kill, and we went over trying to find the Spirit Halloween store at the mall, and we walked the entire mall, and we only saw it at the very end when we were walking out. It's upstairs.
It's upstairs.
Above FYE.
Oh, okay.
What are you going to be looking for? Stuff for the Halloween parade or extraneous
decorations? See what's the hot topics this year.
I bet Beetlejuice is going to be huge at the Spirit Halloween store, right?
Yeah.
All right. So we were also told we're going to have Halloween decorations in here.
Yes.
Get us in the mood. We'll be talking about the KLAQ Haunted House in just a couple of weeks. Coming up for Halloween, we'll be talking about that before you know it. And what's coming up in entertainment news today, Joanna?
You know, a lot of great tidbits came out of Quentin Tarantino's interview with Bill Maher on his podcast.
Right.
And one of my favorite, it's now my new favorite, it's how adamant Quentin Tarantino is about not watching the new Toy Story movies. He's a big fan of them, but he only watched the original three and refuses to watch four and the new one that's coming out.
And he gives his own rationale for
what that is. Yeah, and I'll let you know, or I'll let you hear what he said on Bill Maher's podcast.
All right, very good. Join Glenn Garza, and this is going to be a big Labor Day sale on Sunday at Lucchese Boots. Glenn Garza's going to be there from noon to two on Sunday. It's a huge Labor Day sale at Lucchese, 11751 Gateway Boulevard West. And, you know, that is a world-famous brand that originated right here in Texas. Fact check me on that, I'm pretty sure. I know Tony Lama did, right?
Tony Lama, yeah.
You can save money on handmade boots of all types, as well as men's and women's apparel. Also, some cool prizes, including a $100 Lucchese gift card. Enjoy a cold country time lemonade from our friends at Admiral Beverages while you shop and save and win at Lucchese. 11751 Gateway West in El Paso. That's Sunday from 12 to 2, noon to 2, with Glenn Garza and KLAQ. All right, so when Nico gets here, I'm sure he'll hit the ground running, but...
You're late to work, who gives a f***?
You know, it's not just that he's late. He's allergic to being on time.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
There's something that will not allow him to be on time. It could be his generation, or it could be...
Don't blame it on his generation. I'm the same age as
he is. And you're here on time. And you stay late. Right, so I can't blame everybody in Nico's generation, but he'll be coming up soon. We're going to come back in just a few minutes, and we're going to have Today in Sound Clips. Yeah, so Harris and her running mate, Walls, did their first sit-down interview. They did it together.
Okay.
Yesterday, and we got some audio of that coming up. The Army came out with a rebuke of the Trump campaign for the stunt at Arlington Cemetery.
Oh.
Yeah, the Army actually put out a statement saying the Arlington worker was doing her job, and she was accosted by members of Trump's entourage. It's a pretty big deal for the Army to come out with an official statement on that, but they have. Coming up, we'll have Today in Sound Clips on the way here in just a couple of minutes.
The Daily Calendar.
Hey, you guys, it's August 30th. Today is College Colors Day, so whether you're an alum or about to be, throw on that school spirit. Yesterday was Cabernet Day, so today is Cabernet Sauvignon Day. Fruity cats with attitudes. It's Beach Day and Whale Shark Day, so feed them and give them a kiss. It's Frankenstein Day for the monster novel by Mary Shelley. Short book, 200 pages. What's a book?
I don't know.
And that's your Daily Calendar.
May your lips
check eligibility and vaccine at vaxassist.com.
So where should we go next?
Sponsored by Pfizer.
Attention station employees. Labor Day is coming up. An appropriate name since you guys will all be working. Thank you.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
Hey, it's Friday.
A three-day weekend.
Three-day weekend.
Labor Day weekend is here.
Labor Day weekend.
Oh, there's bound to be traffic, you know, because it's Labor Day weekend and everything. And,
Labor Day
is Labor Day.
Labor Day weekend.
Grilling. I'm just waiting for a hot dog.
Summer is officially over.
We're going to take a little family vacation of our own.
Happy Labor Day.
It's showtime.
Yeah, Labor Day weekend's about to kick off, everybody. Announcement, Nico has entered the building. Nico Ajimian has entered the building. Good morning, buddy.
Good morning.
Do you know where you're going to be later today?
I'm going to be at Chiba Hut.
Yeah. You can drop by Chiba Hut on North Zaragoza.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the East Side Chiba Hut. It's at 3001 North Zaragoza.
And what time is that at?
2 to 4 this afternoon.
2 to 4.
Chiba Hut's having a back-to-school event with lots of prizes and giveaways, including tickets for the Tacos y Mas Festival.
Ooh.
That's happening tomorrow, but you can win tickets to that event.
You know what's happening there?
Yeah, tacos and y mas. Music. They're going to have, you know, some really good musical acts there and plenty of Mexican food. Tacos y Mas Festival. You can win tickets at Chiba Hut later today, 2 to 4 with Nico Ajimian, and that is on the east side at 3001 North Zaragoza. We're just about to get into the Today in Sound Clip segment. I guess I should repeat, we've got a flash flood warning in effect for El Paso County.
For
today.
Until
11
wow.
o'clock tonight, but the bulk of the rain is supposed to come in after noon, so around 1 or maybe 2 o'clock, we're going to be seeing some potentially heavy rainfall. And they do have that flood alert in effect for today. All right, let's... comics. Let's talk about the comedy this weekend. You got your open mic tonight?
I have my show and open mic tonight.
Okay, so professional comedian starting at what time?
At 9:30. That's going to be a showcase of some of the best comics I know. And they're all professionals. It's going to be Jenny Robbins, Anthony Austin Brown, Rogelio Avila, Iggy Sabaniego, myself, and Joe Rodriguez from Las Cruces.
And there will be a cover for this?
That is $5 at the door. And right afterwards, we will go straight into the open mic, hosted by a very funny new local named Fumio.
Mm-hmm. And there's no charge if you come
and
after,
no charge.
After the professional show.
Sure.
It's free admission.
Yeah.
And you can sign up and do comedy if you want to.
Yeah, you can sign up. You can watch. You can get your feet wet by talking to the comedians. They're people, too.
How about at the comic strip this weekend?
Awesome. At the comic strip, you're getting double headliners. It's the two headliner show, Trey Tutson and Charles Allen. I think they're both from L.A. right now. Trey usually comes in. He was the feature for Chris Kattan, usually.
Okay. So when Kattan would come in, he'd be his middle act.
Yeah.
Okay.
But now he's going to be co-headlining with somebody else. Charles Allen. It's great.
That's at the comic strip this weekend.
At the comic strip.
And Jenny's coming by
And
today.
Then Jenny Robbins will be coming by.
Right,
and now, Today in Sound Clips.
All of the day's news with accompanying sound bites and actualities. After weeks of pressure, Vice President Kamala Harris sat down for an interview with CNN's Dana Bash. She said that she supported a ban on fracking in 2019, but she told Dana Bash that she made it clear she no longer wants a ban on fracking and says that she doesn't support the idea of banning it. They called her out on flip-flopping. Harris said that she changed her mind, but her values have not changed. Tim Walz was there too, the Minnesota governor who's Kamala Harris's running mate. They were asked by Dana Bash what would happen on the first day of the Harris-Walz administration.
I will tell you, first and foremost, one of my highest priorities is to do what we can to support and strengthen the middle class.
Here is Harris's response when the interviewer asked why she has not accomplished or achieved her goals as vice president.
Well, first of all, we had to recover as an economy, and we have done that. I'm very proud of the work that we have done that has brought inflation down to less than 3%. The work that we have done to cap the cost of insulin at $35 a month for seniors.
Okay, let me ask anybody this, because that's going to be a big... They're trying to tie Kamala Harris to Joe Biden, and they've made the exact same attacks they were making on Joe Biden. Now they're flipping it to her, but they're saying, well, she was basically tied to him in every decision they made throughout the course of the their administration. Well, a vice president has no power. It's one of the least powerful positions in government. So
they certify the elections, though, I found out.
Generally as a customary thing.
As a ceremonial function.
But
normally.
For people that... I want you to tell me who the most consequential vice president was during their time.
Mike Pence.
Okay, yes. Because of that one decision. But yes, I'm telling you...
Hands down, Mike Pence will go down as maybe the greatest vice president.
They're asking her about her policy accomplishments as vice president. Tell me the policy accomplishments of any other vice president. You can't, because no vice president has any policy accomplishments. There's no such thing.
Dan Quayle misspelled potato in front of a class full of third graders.
Even that was a ceremonial thing to do, right? So a lot of what the vice
president... I've seen Veep. I get what you're driving at.
Right. Okay, I forgot that you have seen Veep.
So I have seen Veep.
Yeah. But a lot of people don't know that, and they're trying to connect her as the, like, person who...
Well, she was the vice president. I mean...
Sure. Yeah. Oh, sure. You're going to be tied to all the outcomes and the things like that. But to make it seem like you were the one to make all the decisions at that time, that's disingenuous.
Harris says that there are going to be consequences for illegal immigration. She says that the immigration measures have taken time because of a blocked, you remember from earlier this year, bipartisan immigration bill that... Apparently, Trump got on the phone with a bunch of congressmen and said, don't vote for this immigration bill.
A bill was crafted, which we supported, which I support. And Donald Trump got word of this bill that would have contributed to securing our border. And because he believes that it would not have helped him politically, he told his folks in Congress, don't put it forward. He killed the bill.
Harris also stressed her, quote, unequivocal and unwavering commitment to Israel's defense. One final clip here. She was asked about Trump questioning her race and making crude B-job comments on his social media site. Harris says it's the same old tired shtick.
He suggested that you happened to turn black recently for political purposes, mm-hmm. questioning a core part of your identity.
Yeah.
Any
same old tired playbook. Next question, please.
Yeah. I think they're driving him crazy by not responding, you know, to the Truth Social
petty. You mean the BJ thing?
The BJ thing, and you know, questioning her race. They're really. Almost like above it is how it looks. And I think it's driving him insane. And I think it's going to make him do even crazier posts.
Well, you know, all of his advisors have said he needs to stick with policy talking points.
He ain't going to. He's not going to do that.
All of his advisors have said that's how he's going to lose. Like, even Lindsey Graham was on CNN saying those things.
The United States Army has defended the Arlington National Cemetery employee who was involved in the Trump incident. That staffer tried to stop members of the Trump campaign from filming a video among the graves of recently fallen service members. That staffer has declined to press charges in the case, but apparently she could have. The Army also said that that employee's professionalism was unfairly attacked. So Let's hear a little bit more of the latest reporting on this story.
What the Army said is that an ANC employee who attempted to ensure adherence to the rules of the ANC was pushed aside.
An Army spokesperson said, quote, this incident was unfortunate, and it is also unfortunate that the ANC employee and her professionalism has been unfairly attacked.
Have you ever been to Arlington Cemetery?
No, I haven't been to Washington, D.C.
I went, but like when I was 20 years old. And we went to Arlington Cemetery and the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. Like, as soon as you walk in there, you're kind of overcome by the solemn nature of the place you're at, you know?
I'm sure it's like a quiet, it, you look reflective. Out over
those rows and rows of grave markers, and they have the guards outside the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. I mean, mm-hmm. It just really impresses upon you when you experience yourself what a solemn place this is.
Yeah.
So, also, some people are upset because in some of the pictures, Trump is giving a thumbs up and smiling at the graveside ceremony, but also the family members of some of the soldiers that were there were also taking those pictures and giving the thumbs up and the smiling, but that doesn't sit right. I say if you lost a child in the service of the country, you can grieve however you want to. Here is Donald Trump disavowing any knowledge of this altercation.
Somebody brought this up yesterday. It doesn't matter whether the parents of that fallen soldier agreed or participated or whatever.
That doesn't change the policy of Arlington National Cemetery.
No, it doesn't. They're not the ones who decide the rules.
So Trump was asked about it, and he really kind of claims that he doesn't know anything about it.
And all of a sudden I hear that somebody that I have no idea who it is got into an argument with somebody else at the cemetery about pictures being taken. I took them at the request of the families, and I'm very happy I did.
In a statement today, an Army spokesperson said that Defense Department regulations, quote, clearly prohibit political activities on cemetery grounds, and that a cemetery employee was, quote, abruptly pushed aside when...
Also, the professionalism being questioned, Trump spokesman Stephen Chung put out that a mentally unhinged Arlington Cemetery employee got into an
altercation.
That's
not professional. So,
well, it's unworthy of those people that are buried there. I mean, it's just, you know, off the reservation crazy.
And the person was probably a Trump campaign photographer who was wanting to take these pictures for...
Well, they put it out on TikTok. They made a video of it, and that is a
political campaign. Activity,
yeah, that's a political activity, and that's not allowed in that part of Arlington Cemetery. If you ever get a chance to go to Arlington, definitely do it. You'll see what I'm talking about as soon as you kind of step into Arlington Cemetery. You get the sense of how solemn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would love to go to Washington in general, but especially to Arlington, yeah. And all the tombstones look the same, or the headstones?
You know, I didn't tour the entire cemetery. We went to, I think, you know, I was there with my dad. We just kind of went. I remember going to the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. And, but the last thing you would do is start posing for pictures, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's kind of weird. Dak Prescott kind of mocked the Cowboys owner, Jerry Jones, in a press conference. They are in a heated negotiation right now. The Cowboys finally decided to pay CeeDee Lamb. Good. But the negotiations are still going on with Dak Prescott. Here, Dak says that he just, a long time ago, quit paying attention to anything Jerry Jones tells the media.
Yeah, I understand that. That's the business and the nature of this game that we play. I stopped, honestly, listening to things that he says to the media a long time ago. So doesn't really hold weight with me.
Prescott says he doesn't care when he gets his extension done with the owner, but it says a lot that he still has no deal.
Mm-hmm. As I said, well, back in camp, it's two parts of this. Both sides have to come to the agreement.
You don't need a deal done before the season.
I don't need a no, no.
Would you like it done before the season?
I think it says a lot if it is or if it isn't. But however, doesn't really matter to me, to be honest with you.
What does it say if it isn't?
Just how people feel.
Have you heard these stories before where there's like arson, and then they link it to somebody who actually works for the fire department.
Mm-hmm.
That, right? That's a crazy thing about firefighters. Not all of them, of course.
Wait, I wouldn't even say. Wait, what are you talking about?
Sometimes they find like a string of arson and they track it back, and it turns out the guy works for the fire department.
When you say it's not all of
it's not even
one person, less than a percent of them.
Right, but
it's more than normal. Maybe.
But it's happened more than once.
Yes, it's happened more than once.
That's all I was trying to say. A firefighter in Canada was arrested for committing a string of arson attacks.
Oh, no.
Setting bales of hay on fire.
Oh, here we go.
Really got into hay bales. Right, that's real work, Nico.
Do you know how many hay bale memes I got yesterday?
Really?
Yeah. And I agree. I was saying baling hay is probably the hardest job of all that we were talking about.
Thank you.
Just not Buzz doing
it. Yeah, no, I did. Okay, listen, here is the Macklin Fire Chief, Justin Bast, talking about the fire set by firefighter Logan Sieben. Here he is talking about those incidents.
It's a lot for volunteer department. A lot of the guys are leaving work. Most of the calls have been during work hours. So there again, that's taxing. We've had some instances where they've tried to light standing crop. It was a little bit green. It didn't burn. We've been very fortunate that the fires have been small.
Those green hay bales. So a bale of hay might weigh anywhere from 90 to 110 pounds.
The green ones got water in them.
Not the big round wheels that you see out. I'm talking about the rectangular bales. But if they cut them a little early and they're still green, it's an extra 20 or 30 pounds. Those were the worst, the green ones, man.
Even
yes, I used to work for a living. I used to do demanding physical labor.
For a year. For a summer.
Every summer, I don't know, through high school
and
middle school.
And then as a 10-year-old, sure, they're going to really drive the 10-year-old hard.
No, I didn't start. When I was 10, I drove the truck because I wasn't strong enough to lift the hay bales.
You'll just keep going if we... Joanna,
I'll sit here and talk about this until the cows come home.
Joanna, a lot of the memes that people were sending me had a little child driving this tractor.
Wait, yeah. Were those actual pictures actual or AI pictures. Generated? Yeah, that was that. You weren't on a road. You were out in some farmer's pasture someplace, and the older kids would throw the hay on the back. But then by the time I was 12, I could lift the hay bales, so I was doing that.
Did Lee do it too?
Yeah, not as much. I mean,
that's his brother.
He was a very small kid. Like in high school, even he weighed like 90 pounds.
Really?
Well, he was just real skinny and, you know, not. He was a great athlete. He got a tennis scholarship, became a tennis pro.
Oh.
There's a homeowners association, okay? In South Carolina. Yeah, right. Have you ever had to deal with a homeowner? Have you ever had to deal with a homeowner?
Of course not.
Okay.
But I do know about them.
Right. Sometimes they make ridiculous demands that don't make any sense.
The reason you stumbled when you looked at me, because you knew, wait, you don't own a house.
Yeah,
really?
But I know your mom and dad might live in it. They live in a historic neighborhood. They might have some covenants or something because it's such a historic
neighborhood. As a historic neighborhood, yeah, it does have that.
Like you might not be able to put up a basketball goal in your drive. I don't know if that's the case, but that's
for historic districts, sure, you can't make too many cosmetic changes that will change the look of it.
You got to get approval for almost anything you do if you have a homeowners association or some kind of neighborhood covenant or whatever. So the Homeowners Association in South Carolina issued a cease and desist after some kids were spotted playing on a patch of grass. Not organized sports. It wasn't like they were having practice. It was just some kids who went out and played on some grass. And
cease and desist.
Whose grass?
I guess it was a commons area for the home, you know, for the people who lived in that area.
Okay.
Whatever was covered by the Homeowners Association.
You can't step on the grass? Is that
the families in the community that had children were made aware of the cease and desist about their kids playing on a grassy field in the middle of the neighborhood. Here are homeowners from both sides of the argument making their cases.
The best way to parent my kids is allowing them to be outside, be healthy, be active. This is absolutely not an organized sport. The only thing organized about it is these 5, 6, 7, 8-year-olds saying, hey, do you want to go play football?
They have coach, they have whistles, they have tents, they have water, and they've taken over the circle.
Well, before you know it, the Carolina Panthers will be playing here.
It's so great to see the kids outside. But these people, they push it from 10 to now 30 people.
This might be it. They sucked at sports when they were kids.
They sucked at sports.
Do you notice the second couple that's against the kids playing are, you can tell they're older, right? And the first lady has kids that are that
young
age.
Yeah.
Yeah. Finally, you know what's coming up on Labor Day? A big matchup. Chestnut versus Kobayashi. Unfinished beef.
Netflix keeps promoing it. And the pictures they have of them promoing have each of them like with their arms linked and then shoving a hot dog in their mouth.
Joey Chestnut versus Kobayashi in the hot dog eating rematch. If you thought you didn't have exciting things to do on Labor Day, boy, are you wrong. You got to tune this in.
To be the greatest, it takes a hunger you understand. On September 2nd, watch the greatest competitive eaters go head-to-head for the first time in 15 years in a rematch where winner takes all. Chestnut versus Kobayashi, Unfinished Beef, live only on Netflix.
That will be 1 o'clock El Paso time on Monday.
On Sunday, should we get together and watch it?
It's not going to happen until Monday.
On Monday,
Sunday,
should we get to...
Sunday comes before Monday.
On Monday,
so unless you have a time machine...
On Monday, should we get together and watch it?
I don't know if I'll be that bored. I might be, though.
Chestnut.
Wow, Joey Chestnut.
Kobayashi.
Kobayashi puts it in.
Get ready for dog snoggin, wiener stuff, and bun golf in action.
Most amazing competitive eating contest I have ever seen.
It's Unfinished Beef.
You saw Kobayashi. Did you see him at all? Did you make eye contact? And what were your thoughts?
Absolutely not. If he was a real man, he'd be on the stage.
Labor Day.
Good morning, Chuck Armstrong here, and I will be along tonight at 7 to get your weekend off to a rockin' start with Loudwire Nights. Then tomorrow at 5, it's 2 hours of Ultimate Metallica.
HSA and FS. Book an appointment for your free fitting at goodfeet.com or just stop in. Walk-ins are welcome.
Live from the KLAQ studios, the Buzz Adams Morning Show. Courtesy of Blasheen, Vias, and Enderman Personal Injury Lawyers.
At gvilaw.com.
Just about to get to the Mo Show calendar and daily almanac of events. We have that coming up here in just a moment.
Woo! Did you...
Next to last day of...
August.
August, that's right. Mm. We're going to flip over to September on Sunday.
September,
right.
Did you understand what I was trying to tell you coming back on air?
No. I don't even remember what you were... Something about Sonic the Hedgehog.
People have been wanting us to do... or wanting you to do a trailer recap or review of the new Sonic Hedgehog. Sonic the Hedgehog 3.
I don't even know what Sonic the Hedgehog is.
It's a video game.
Yeah, but I didn't see any of these movies. I've never played the game. What insight am I going to offer?
That's a very good point. And that's kind of what I wanted the listener to hear, because they keep asking. Buzz doesn't like Sonic the Hedgehog.
I mean, I don't have an opinion on Sonic the Hedgehog.
Jim
Carrey had a crazy mustache?
Yeah, he played Eggman. And then
they came out with the Sonic the Hedgehog, and a lot of people were horrified by the way it looked, so they went back and redesigned it. Have you ever heard about that?
Yes, because it was too realistic and looked gross.
And that completes all of my knowledge pertaining to Sonic the Hedgehog. I don't know anything else.
Well,
other than
Keanu
that.
Reeves is going to be playing Shadow the Hedgehog. Ben Schwartz is the voice of Sonic.
Wait, there's other hedgehogs in this thing?
Yeah, with like superpowers.
Okay. Very interesting.
All right. So probably not going to happen.
I'm not qualified. Not qualified to do that. So we won't be into September until we come back to work on Tuesday. And I'll do like a full rundown of everything happening. But do you want to hear some of the stuff that's going to happen next month?
Yeah, definitely.
Thursday, NFL season kicks off with the Chiefs hosting the Ravens. That's the official regular season. First game is going to be on Thursday. Then on Friday of next week, Packers playing the Philadelphia Eagles in Brazil.
Ooh.
The Paralympic Games just started in Paris. They're going to go on through September the 8th. And tennis fans, the U.S. Open is underway, going on through September the 9th. Some of the movies coming out in the month of September, Beetlejuice hits theaters Wednesday. The animated movie Transformers 1 is going to come out September 20th. And Francis Ford Coppola's epic sci-fi drama Megalopolis also comes out September 27th. On TV, the Golden Bachelor is back on ABC.
It's the Golden Bachelorette.
Oh, Bachelorette, I'm sorry. And the premiere of the Batman spinoff series, The Penguin. Can you picture the Penguin from the
yes.
Robert Pattinson movie? Oh. You know who that was?
Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell.
Yeah, no, he's great. I've been watching a lot of Max lately, and so they have the trailer for that constantly going for the series.
The Batman with Robert Pattinson is probably my favorite Batman movie of all time.
Really?
It's the most grounded, you know?
It's gritty.
Like, yeah. if he's at a crime scene and the cops decide we're going to take this in, he has to fight his way out through all the cops. You know? He can't
magically... Be like, hey, buddy.
Yeah, right. I thought it was great. I only thought it was great the second time I saw it. The first time, meh. But the second time I saw the Robert Pattinson Batman. I take it back. Joker with Joaquin Phoenix is my all-time favorite Batman.
Oh, okay.
It was great.
Yeah, that's a curve. Does Robert Pattinson's Batman do, like, drugs?
He injects himself possibly with the stuff that gave Bane his powers, Venom.
Oh.
Or he gives himself a shot and suddenly gets, like, momentarily stronger in a big showdown with... Spoilers, with the Riddler.
So it's not heroin.
I don't think heroin has that. I don't know much about heroin. Just what I learned from Trainspotting. That's about it. All right, let's go ahead and get to the Mo Show calendar and daily almanac of events. Today is August the 30th. Today's National Beach Day. We got a big beach in El Paso.
Oh, I love the beaches.
The whole city.
Yeah.
We just don't have an ocean to go along with all the beach we have.
No, just we're one big beach.
Today is National Grief Awareness Day. And today is National Toasted Marshmallow Day. All right. National Frankenstein Day. And it's Labor Day weekend, of course. Some of the celebrities having birthdays today include... Singer Baby Rexha, who's 35. You guys familiar with BB Rexha?
BB. It's BB Rexha.
Retired tennis player Andy Roddick has a birthday today. He's 42. And a birthday for Cameron Diaz, who's 52.
Andy Roddick married Brooklyn Decker?
I guess that's the case, yeah. A Brooklyn Decker sounds like something on UrbanDictionary.com. Hey, man, I went to this guy's house and I left him a Brooklyn Decker for when he gets home. Actor Michael Chiklis from The Shield. He was also the Thing mm-hmm. in a couple of Fantastic Four movies. He is 61 today. Comedian Lewis Black, 76. And Warren Buffett, at one time, he was going back and forth with Bill Gates as the richest man in the world, but now he is only number six on the richest people in the world. But his net worth is $147 billion. Warren Buffett is 94 years old today.
Did you read the end of that thing?
About Warren Buffett?
Yeah.
Elon Musk is the richest person in the world with $239 billion. Bernard Arnault is number two. He's got $191 billion. And then Jeff Bezos has dropped back to number three with $191 billion. You know, Elon Musk has kind of like destroyed Twitter.
Super destroyed.
And really had a bunch of failed business models, but he's still the richest person in the world, even with all that.
Well, I was looking at the very last sentence where Warren Buffett wants the government to tax him more and, quote, stop coddling the super rich.
Easy for him to say. He's 94. How long is he going to be here? And, of course, we have Labor Day upon us.
Mm.
You might even be celebrating Labor Day a little bit early by slacking off at work. Showing up late, that kind of stuff. Yeah. It's already halfway Labor Day for you folks, right?
It's Labor Day weekend, and there's Dad. He's been drinking Schlitz malt liquor since he woke up, and now he's going to grill burgers once he gets the Kingsford charcoal briquettes lit.
Look out!
And here's his wife, Nancy. She's been hitting the bottle, too, but nobody knows because she hides her vodka in a coffee cup. There goes Timmy and his friends on Schwinn Stingrays. They're going to light leftover firecrackers from the 4th of July in the parking lot at Bob's Big Boy.
Where are my fingers?
Yes, Labor Day weekend. Because celebrating the American labor movement just means a three-day weekend.
This Labor Day weekend, get to a sale.
/free. Recruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show, Monday through Friday, 5 to 10. KLAQ and KLAQ HD1, El Paso, a Town Square media station.
Joanna has the Hollywood Chisme coming up in just a moment. We do have a dining deal that's going to go live today, not yesterday. I don't know why I was in a Friday mindset yesterday.
And then in our meeting, our boss is all like, and none of you caught it.
Nobody else noticed.
I have to admit. Yeah, I tune Buzz out every now and then.
Starting this morning at 10 a.m., as soon as the morning show's over, Oasis Lanes is our dining deal this week. You get $50 Ooh. Gift cards for only $25. You can use those for food. They make delicious brick oven pizza at Oasis Lanes. Or you can use it for gameplay, game cards. 40 lanes of bowling. Oasis Lanes also has an arcade with virtual reality games, sports simulators, indoor-outdoor amusement park rides for adults and children. And do try some of that brick oven pizza if you like a good pizza.
I had my project graduation at Oasis Lanes.
Oh, your what?
Project graduation.
What is that?
It's like the party that the school usually sponsors for all the seniors, and it's like a lockdown usually, like they'll have everybody there.
And you stay all night or something?
For some places, and they'll do like raffles and, you know, things like that. Joanna, did you have project graduation?
We did, yeah. I was at a country club, but Ooh. My parents threw me a party.
Project graduation, wow.
You know where they used to have the project graduation, and I was so excited. It was at Western Playland. And then that year that we graduated, like, that's when Western Playland was
moved.
Sold.
When they moved from their location at
Escarate.
Yep. Once again, you could get $50, good for food, non-alcoholic beverages, and game cards from Oasis Lanes. For that, you only pay $25. And the way to do that is as soon as 10 o'clock rolls around, go to KLAQ.com, click Dining Deals. You'll find that on the must-read bar, KLAQ.com. Or if you're using the KLAQ mobile app, we've got a Dining Deals button there. Live at 10 o'clock this morning. Remind me of all the guests that we have coming in today, Nico.
We've got Trey Tutson and Charles Allen stopping by a little bit later. They're going to be the two headliners at the El Paso Comic Strip. One show tonight, two shows tomorrow, and one show on Sunday. And then I have a show tonight at 9:30 at Scenics Bar and Kitchen. It is a showcase of the best comedians, local comedians, and professional local comedians. And then right afterwards, it's the open mic, the normal one that we have. So a very fun filled day. Oh, Jenny Robbins is going to be coming by.
Yep.
If she wakes up.
Jenny's going to be at the professional comedy show tonight. Yes. Yeah. Right?
She's just in for a night, and she's leaving back to L.A. tomorrow.
Here's something you can try just in time for Labor Day. If you want a new drink mix, try Gator Wine. I just realized this sounds like an endorsement, but it's not. I'm just talking about this food blogger. Okay, Gator Wine.
It's not really an endorsement because it's not one product. It's like a weird combination that somebody's come up with.
It's Gatorade.
Right.
It's Gatorade and wine. And let me find the
I've
guy
heard
about
this
here.
Exact one weeks ago. I remember seeing a video of somebody trying it out, and they were like, it's stupidly good. It's delicious.
Yeah. Here is YouTuber Andrew Ray giving a review of Gator Wine. Again, that is equal parts light blue glacier freeze Gator and any cheap red wine. Andrew Ray suggests you don't get anything more expensive than $12 a bottle for the wine.
It's not like anything I've ever tasted. If I'm being honest, I'd rather drink this than Barefoot or Yellowtail. I drink that on the rocks. The more I'm drinking it, the more I like it. It's kind of what it's giving is like almost a sangria vibe because you added this fruit juice, for lack of a better word, to wine. So it's this kind of wine cocktail vibe.
And there is that is the specific recipe, by the way. Don't go and get some lemon lime. Think Gatorade. Think it's going to be the same thing because it's not. The recipe is equal parts light blue glacier freeze Gatorade and any cheap red wine that's less than $12 a bottle. At first, the guy didn't like it, but then he the more he drank it, the more he liked it. I find I'm that way with any alcoholic beverage. I may not like it at first, but the more of it I drink, the better it gets. For that, they used the Glacier Freeze Gatorade plus a cheap bottle of Barefoot Pinot Noir.
I think Glacier Freeze is my favorite flavor to begin with, so that's good news.
I just go by colors.
I like give me dark blue, green.
Give me a yellow. My friend wants a red.
And thank you, Lauren, in our app chat for maybe correcting me that it's Project Celebration. I'm pretty sure when I was in high school, it was called Project Graduation at the time.
When I was in high school, it was called Project Inebriation. Here is Joanna Barba with today's Hollywood Chisme, entertainment news, and more. Good morning, Joanna.
Oh, good morning. From all over the world gathered around their computers and phones on Wednesday in anticipation of a major Linkin Park announcement at 2:15 p.m. However, when a mysterious countdown clock hit zero, there were no news from the long
event. Nothing happened?
Nothing happened. Now Linkin Park have revealed that the announcement will come on September 5th. The social media post reads, be part of something. September 5th, LincolnPark.com. On Wednesday, when the band's countdown clock hit zero, instead of an announcement, the clock started ticking back up. However, some internet sleuths noticed a glitch at 9:05, suggesting that the news would indeed come on September 5th instead. Amid the speculation is that the band will reform with a new singer to play shows in 2025. Sum 41 frontman Derek Whibley was rumored to be that singer after he teased his own Wednesday announcement, but he shot those rumors down saying, quote, "I'm not joining Oasis or Linkin Park or any other band for that matter." Earlier this year, reports surfaced that Linkin Park were planning to reunite for a 2025 tour with a female vocalist taking place.
That's correct. The rumor is that they're gonna get a female lead singer, but I guess we'll find out.
We'll
Thursday.
Find out Wednesday.
Thursday. I thought the 5th was Thursday.
Oh, is it? I didn't even check to see what day.
I have a pretty.
If only we had e-calendars to check out. The 5th is Thursday.
Oh, it is Thursday. I kept writing Wednesday. Linkin Park have not toured since Chester Bennington tragically took his own life in 2017. But we'll wait to see on Thursday what the news is.
Well, I know the 5th is Thursday because I have a medical procedure
that is
going to...
His first colonoscopy.
And that's...
you weren't in the meeting yesterday.
I'm not confirming, nor am I denying, that that's the date of my colonoscopy.
Oh, that's quick. You were saying to Justin this week.
I thought it would take 3 months to set up.
Yeah. You were hoping, probably.
Well, I get the celebrity treatment.
We're okay. Kidding.
He gets extra lube. What does that mean?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I get an extra dollop.
Oh, my God. Tallulah Willis gave an update on her father Bruce Willis's ongoing battle with frontotemporal dementia and shared how her family leans on each other for support. The youngest daughter of Willis and Demi Moore told E! News in an interview that her father is doing the same, which in his situation is a good thing. She said, quote, "Our visits have so much love and I feel that overarches anything for me." Tallulah explained that being able to have a connection with her father is what keeps them going. And despite noting how hard this journey is for her family, the 30-year-old revealed that Bruce's health condition has created an opportunity for more love.
Well,
God, every time I see a picture about Bruce Willis, I get scared.
Because you think it's going to be like Bruce Willis.
Right.
I wonder if his kids, in a way, appreciate the fact that they probably get to spend more time with him than they ever got to when he was, a really busy actor.
Acting and doing all these things. Yeah, maybe. It was announced yesterday that the new Jurassic World movie called Jurassic World Rebirth will come out on July 2nd of 2025. It stars Scarlett Johansson, Jonathan Bailey, and Mahershala Ali. In the movie, a brave team has to collect DNA from the biggest dinosaurs on land, sea, and air to make a life-changing drug. The Earth is now a tough place for dinosaurs, and they live only in special warm areas where they used to thrive. Johansson plays Zora Bennett, who leads a secret mission to get DNA from the biggest dinosaurs, but her mission gets messy when a family's boat trip goes wrong because of dinosaur attacks.
Some family ends up
stranded on an island with a big hidden secret.
Hey, if it worked for the first one.
Bailey will play a paleontologist and Mahershala Ali is Zora's trusted team leader. Steven Spielberg is one of the executive producers. This is the fourth movie in the Jurassic World series, with the previous ones making each over $1 billion worldwide.
Does anybody over the age of 12 get excited about a Jurassic Park movie?
Scarlett Johansson did. She loves it.
She's
so excited.
I think the only one I've
basically
seen...
Basically, the first one was a good movie.
The first one. I've seen that first one.
And then... None of them have really been great other than the first one, which was that was eye-popping when that first came out.
I was going to say, I think it's about the spectacle of how the dinosaurs are getting bigger and bigger and bigger, but at some point it's just...
Right. They got to make up...
Strange credulity.
Yeah. more and more implausible plot lines.
Yeah, but this one has Scarlett Johansson.
Okay.
So... Think about
fine actor.
The Toy Story series, or at least the first three films in the franchise, have a friend in Quentin Tarantino. Joining Bill Maher on his Club Random podcast, the Oscar-winning director made a surprising revelation that he considers the third film in the series to be one of the best movies he's ever seen, but that his affection for the story made him reluctant to accept future sequels, including the planned Toy Story 5. Here is what he had to say.
But I am a big fan of the Toy Story trilogy. The third one is just magnificent. It's one of the best movies I've ever seen. And if you've seen the other two, then it's devastating.
Is it a cartoon?
Yeah, it's a cartoon. But the thing is, then 3 years later or something, they did a fourth. And I have no desire to see it.
Right.
You literally ended the story as perfect as you could.
Right.
So, no, I don't care if it's good. I'm done.
Why put the...
I am done. It can still be good, but I'm done.
But so this is why there's no Kill Bill 3.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Because you feel like...
No, I did. I killed Bill.
Right. Is the third one the one where they almost get incinerated at the end?
Yeah. That one is devastating. And it is a good end to that trilogy.
Yeah, right. They could have just put a nice bow on it.
It could have ended there.
Is that the one with the collector, the toy collector?
No, that's the second one.
Okay, man.
That introduces Jesse.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
His girlfriend.
That's not his girlfriend.
Jesse's not his girlfriend?
Uh-huh. No, Bo Peep is his girlfriend. Wow, you haven't seen the Toy Story movie?
I have. I didn't pay attention to the relationships that closely.
Okay.
You know Mr. Potato Head was married to Mrs. Potato Head, right?
Well,
in other Toy Story news,
according to you guys, Jesse and Woody shouldn't end up together.
They just didn't. They weren't hooking it
up. That's like Mr. Potato Head is going to... Or Mrs. Potato Head's going to bang the Slinky Dog.
The Slinky Dog, yeah. Right.
Another Toy Story.
Good callback on the Slinky Dog.
Yeah. Disney recently teased at its D23 convention that Toy Story 5 would follow the character's struggle to capture a child's attention away from digital devices.
Oh. Will your iPad be able to talk now when you leave it?
That'd be hilarious. With your entertainment news, I'm Joanna Barba.
I get along Liberty Weekend.
Spanish. Gracias.
Language for life. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com.
Hey, what are your plans for Labor Day weekend?
I'm going to sell adult lemonade. It's just normal lemonade, but I'm going to have a boob out. Boob.
Staycation.
I'm inventing barbecued ice cream. Oh, never mind.
I'm going to do a DIY massage, but just the happy ending. Don't look at me.
It's Labor Day. I'm going into labor.
Have a happy Labor Day. Be safe out there.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
There is, I guess, a heavy rain advisory, a flood advisory in effect for El Paso. Yeah, it happens sometimes. Today, and the rain is expected to come into the area around 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock this afternoon, but they got us under a flood advisory until 11 o'clock tonight. And Joanna has traffic for us. Well, what's happening?
Well, we're seeing major delays this morning. All lanes are closed at I-10 East between Artcraft and Red Road due to an accident overnight. Traffic extends to Trans Mountain, so you'll want to avoid the area and find an alternate route. If you are heading in that direction this morning, again, that's I-10 East at Artcraft and Red Road. All lanes are closed this morning until further notice.
We've got guests in the studio. This guy, I got to get an update from Trey from the last time we spoke, which was, I don't know, like 5 years
ago. 5 years ago.
Yeah, 5 years ago. But I'll introduce both of our guests in just a second. This is the final day that we have a ghost song of the day for the month of August. You guys ever heard of a band called Ghost?
I have.
The real...
Are they new?
Mm-hmm.
I would say last 10 years.
Oh, great.
Right? Would you say the band's about 10 years old?
Yeah,
Joanne?
That's
something
a,
like that.
Good one.
They're real spooky. Like they've got that Satan makeup on stage. You know, they're like a, they look like one death of those metal bands, but they're real. Their music is very poppy sounding, very pop.
Did they write a diss song about Drake?
I don't, it's hard for me to tell what anybody's saying in any song anymore.
That's what happened.
I have to go online and look up the lyrics to know what anybody's talking about.
What kind of music you listen to? What if you if I was in the car with you right now, what would we be listening to if we drove to Houston?
Honest to God.
The news.
Probably the news.
Oh, no.
I'd be on Sirius and I'd have CNN, MSNBC, Fox, oh, just
Charles would jump out of the car.
I'd jump out that car before the first gas stop.
You got AARP ears. That's crazy.
If I were listening to music, classic rock.
Classic rock.
Yeah, like classic rock.
Earl Wenkeen.
Oh, yeah. I like Texas country. Like, you know, Austin has a country scene that's distinctive from Nashville's country scene. So I like Texas.
So you like country. So you like Lil Nas X.
I did. Yeah, man. I thought that was a real good song. You could go anywhere without hearing it.
Right, right,
you go
right
to a baseball game, they'd be playing Lil Nas
you
X over the loudspeaker.
You was never really rooting for me anyway.
I like that Beyonce country album that
okay
came out.
You
I
know,
think that's pretty,
you know?
Yeah, I thought it was all right. That one song, the Texas Hold'em
yeah
song.
Texas
I thought that was a good song.
Okay.
There's some interesting stuff going on in country music, yeah.
But classic rock is mainly where you at.
No, I you know, I'll like anything if it's good. You know, if I like it, I like it.
Right.
Why? What should I get into that I'm not into?
Well, you should stop being into the news. I'll say that. That's, let's start with what you shouldn't be into.
I think Beyonce made that country song to piss off white people that really like country music. Because she only made one song, then she stopped. Or did she do a whole album?
I did a whole album. It was like 42 album tracks.
Oh, no,
on
she
that
wasn't trolling. She was serious. Damn.
Maybe, but it probably did piss off a lot of country fans.
It did.
Imagine if Taylor Swift did a hip-hop album. I would want to hear that just off the fact that it's Taylor Swift rapping.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But she don't got enough booty to be a lady hip hop rapper.
What are you gonna what are you gonna twerk with?
Yeah, exactly.
You got no junk in the trunk,
no
lady.
Junk.
Yeah, she's doing a lot of hair twirling. But I don't want to dog out.
Our guests are Trey Tudson and Charles Allen.
Yeah.
They're co-headlining, I guess, this week at the comic strip.
Yes, we are.
So the ghost song of the day, this is the final one. We've been doing it all month long. Everybody who is a daily winner gets the ghost concert movie soundtrack right here, right now. And then on Tuesday, we're going to do a drawing from all of our daily winners. They get an autographed guitar signed by Tobias Forge, a.k.a. Papa Emeritus. From Ghost, and the song is going to be in the 5 o'clock hour today. You might catch this on your ride home from work. Between 5 and 6, listen for Rats. Rats by Ghost. Let's hear a little bit, Joanna. Rats. I like the lyrics.
We could listen to this on the way to Houston.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
But how about like Jake Tapper on CNN?
That's all you would need is just the news playing while that's playing.
Yeah, in the background. Yeah, we could listen to the news.
Oh, playing both at the same time.
Yeah,
like a mashup.
Trump's leading in the polls.
I hit him up.
Joanna is. Thank you for playing that. When you hear that call. When you hear that song played in the 5 o'clock hour, you want to be the. What are we doing? What the hell are we
caller
doing?
Caller 13. 13,
right. Because, all right, it's confusing, but it's caller 13. You want to use the studio line when you hear it, 915-910-4995. All of our daily winners on Tuesday, we're going to draw one and give that autographed guitar to them. Well, welcome back.
Man, that's good.
Welcome
to be back,
Trey. Trey Tudson and Charles are both from Texas.
Yes.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Yeah. Around Houston?
I'm Houston. He's way away from Houston.
Yeah.
If I end up with Charles at, my life is, it really fell off. If I end up in Crockett, Texas.
Crockett. How many people in Crockett?
Since I left, what, nine? No. I'm just playing. If it's anybody in Crockett listening, I'm just kidding. All 12 of y'all, I'm just playing. Don't be like this.
It's fair.
Yeah, but no, it's like 1,500.
With Houston, it's tough because you got Sugarland, and that's technically, I guess, a different city, but some people think it's Houston. And
yeah, but Crockett is outside of like 100 miles away from
Houston. Yeah. They like to level out the population, they start counting cows and all kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah.
Because it's so little people.
You go to Crockett when you're a fugitive in Houston.
Or you don't go by choice, and you're a cop fugitive, and you go to TDC.
Yeah, exactly.
Ain't nothing up there but prison camp.
Would you say you were country?
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely country, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Farm stuff or
not
just small
farm
town?
Country,
more small town country.
Yeah, like memorials and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
Like I'm not good old boy, but the black version of it, if you know what I mean.
Is there a name for that?
I'm a hood good old boy. That's the name for it.
I'm a hood old boy.
A hood old boy. I got it the same time you did. Just a hood old boy.
Never meaning no harm.
Never meaning no harm. Been in trouble with the law. Well,
I ain't been in trouble with the law.
I ain't been in trouble with the law.
That's funny. You know, lyrics past good old boy. I only know just the good old boy and never
making
know
their way. The
oh
only
God.
Way they know how.
Don't know nothing else.
That's just a little bit more than the law would allow.
Oh, my God.
He is country. Yeah. He is a hood old boy.
Usually when I hear that song, it's time to leave.
Yeah. It is.
So Trey was in a studio with another comics, Ham Slate, or Slate Ham.
Slate Ham.
Slate Ham, right. And
you were telling us about your unique wife-girlfriend situation.
When I first came here,
2019,
I had a wife and a girlfriend. We was all living together, and it was a great time in my life.
A magical time, it sounds like.
It was a magical time. The stress of it hadn't quite kicked in. We lasted a while. We had an anniversary.
That's a thruple, full-on thruple kind of situation.
Full-on thruple situation. We went and did everything together. Everything. We did everything together.
Who approached who about this arrangement, or did it just kind of happen?
Well, this is because you was like, he was trying to figure out how to do this,
yeah,
y'all.
How do you do
and
that?
He went
I can't
about
imagine
it all wrong.
How to even, like, you go to your wife if you're married, and it's like, hey, how would you feel about us having a girlfriend?
So what you have to do is you have to make it her idea.
Yeah.
you gotta, all the men out there listening, the way to pull all of this off is you have to have masterful manipulation. You have to have real good skills at manipulating people. So what I did was I asked her, was she into certain things? Hey, have you ever...
Your wife?
I just asked her, what are some of the things...
After you were married?
We was into we was married, we was into it, we was, you know, it was riding.
Married, so you're asking her, what are you into?
What's your things? What's some of the things that you into just to
don't
spice
hold
up
back.
Whatever? Yeah.
Don't have any reservations.
She
just
was
go
like,
ahead and tell me.
You know, this, that, and the fourth. I'd like, you know, maybe another lady. That might be a fun thing. I was like, okay. I said, well, what if there was a lady out there that loved me just as much as you loved me? And she said, I don't think you got it like that. I said, look, I'll tell you what. I'm going to show you that I do have it like that. It's a challenge. So she said, look, if you can get a yes from the girl, you can get a yes from me. So I hit the girl up and I was like, hey.
That was a challenge.
Exactly. You want to be me and my wife's girlfriend. And
was the girl already like your action
on the side?
Did you already know the girl and all that?
Well, she kind of, that's where it kind of got messed up at. But pick a lady. If you're going to do this, fellas, you got to pick a woman you know is infatuated with you already. Don't just try to pick somebody up at the gas station unless you got thousands of dollars.
Trey, you do realize you soliciting pimping right now. That's all you do. You basically just dry snitching on yourself.
Yeah, I'm really not. I'm just trying to help people go to Utah.
Sure, Ike Turner must be turning over in his grave right now.
He done stole my game. This is what I did to anime. Eat your cake, anime.
You make her eat cake on her birthday, too? What if they were setting you up the whole time and they was making you think it was your idea?
Right.
Make you think it was
That's what I was thinking.
Women are smarter than us.
That maybe your wife is like, oh, this guy.
I need some
girl to keep me company.
Okay, so you said those were good years of your life. So I guess
they were fun years.
Are you still with either of the women?
One of them stayed. I'll just say that. One of them stayed, and it was not my wife.
Okay.
wow.
My wife.
Did the two women have a falling out or something?
It was a lot of fights. The end of it, it was Jerry Springer. I was breaking up a lot of fights
between
before
the two of them.
I was breaking up.
How would y'all show up at church? All three of you together just walking down the aisle?
So this is what I'm trying to tell y'all. The bonding process of why I did this. My dad is my dad's church. He needed a youth program. And I said, Dad, I got that covered. So I made them start up the youth program, like the children's church.
So they could work together.
Scandalous. So that they could bond.
Welcome to Third Ward Baptist Church. We are a polygamy-friendly environment.
Charles,
you ain't even got nowhere no shoes.
Charles, wouldn't this be a major scandal in any church you've ever heard of?
Oh, yeah. He said his daddy run the church and he come in.
Did your dad know what the deal was?
I had no idea.
Nobody had no idea.
He put y'all in charge of the youth program.
So he
boy.
Just thought, oh, it's my son's
that's
wife. It's my daughter-in-law and her friend.
Yeah.
And her friend.
And her friend that's doing it, whatever. So nobody knew. So a few people knew.
In the church?
One person.
Probably
knew.
The kids.
But one person in the church knows. Everybody in the church is going to know.
Right. This is what's scary, though. When you do something like this, the attraction. I mean, we was at a Hooters. Almost had a harem. Almost had like four, five.
Could have picked up a couple of Hooters girls.
Almost had like four, five of them at the house.
That's how Diddy got started.
Man, listen, when I be hitting these stories, I'm like, whoo, I was almost there. I just didn't have enough money.
So you're saying that having a wife and a girlfriend gave this confidence, this aura to you, that you would just be going out and girls would be looking at you?
Because we'd be eating together. And they'd be like, so, you know, we'd talk and they'd be like, what's the dynamic here?
The Hooters waitress.
The waitress.
Would ask, what's this all about?
Well, who are y'all? They're getting to know us. And I'm like, my wife would be like, well, this is my husband and this is our girlfriend. And the women would be like, oh, it'd be like a moth to
that
a light.
That was a turn on to
And
them.
They looking at me going, how did you do it? I'm like, well, I mean, you come on over here.
Buzz is taking notes like, okay, harem is possible if...
If you got money.
Buzz, you are one step away from a harem.
Wow. What do you mean?
Another woman?
You got money?
You got the money.
I don't even have one woman.
He's got the money. For real? Though.
I got no... What?
Well, you got like half of one.
No, I don't.
Oh, explain that.
Did you have one just hanging out at your
house? A little person?
No. Yeah, that's right. It's my dwarf girlfriend.
She's magical.
Don't leave her around me.
It's a Mexican lady, but she doesn't have any legs. You know what her name is?
Hilarious.
What? Consuelo.
Wow.
I don't know Spanish.
I don't know if it...
Joanna, did you get it?
Is it politically correct to laugh at that? Because that was funny as hell.
Yeah, right.
If he said it, I'm sure going to
All right, listen, let's get a break going here.
Okay.
Trey Hudson's in the studio. He's the one who had the... And the wife bailed
the amazing
on
wife.
I had to... We'll come back to that. I had to leave the wife.
Oh, you did?
I left.
And took the girlfriend with you.
Yeah, reunited with the girlfriend.
I think that's kind of like the concern in the first place. If you approached a woman, it's like, well, what if they like each other better and I get iced out?
Oh, and they leave together?
No.
Well,
that you left with the girlfriend, but not
well,
the
I
wife.
Didn't leave with the girlfriend.
Oh, God.
You know what I mean?
Right. Yes, you got to come back.
The wife left the situation. She was like, neither one of y'all can't please me. I'm out.
Let's just say this, Trey. I would watch this show.
Oh, God. Yeah. If this were a reality show, I'd watch this.
Yeah, yeah. We'll see what's up.
All right, at the comic strip, and this is tonight and Saturday. Right?
We got 8 o'clock tonight, Friday, and Saturday we got a 7:30 and a 10 p.m. You should definitely come out.
Come out, see Trey Hudson, Charles Allen. We'll be talking to them more when we come back right after this.
Coming up after the Buzz Adams Morning Show, Glenn Garza and Daniel Polis.
Open your account today. As for complete details, life is good under the arch. National average is subject to change at any time.
Live from the KLAQ studios, the Buzz Adams Morning Show. Courtesy of Glashine, Vias, and Enderman personal injury lawyers.
At gvilaw.com.
Yeah. Okay.
Trey Tudson is here. Charles Allen is here. They're both performing and co-headlining at the Comic Strip this weekend with 8 o'clock show tonight, 7:30 and 10?
No, yeah.
On Saturday.
Saturday, 7:30 and 10. Tonight, 8 p.m., 10. One show.
Okay.
Come out.
Come out. Did you guys perform last night?
We performed last night.
How's the crowd?
It was fun. Very fun crowd. Yep. We had a good time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a blast. It's always fun when we come here to El Paso, see all the thick Mexican women.
Right.
I'd clean up here. I'd have a triple-double here.
I thought of a question. So after the throuple mm-hmm. fell apart, uh-huh. however it happened, mm-hmm. you're still with the girlfriend?
Well,
to this day?
It sounds like the girlfriend left.
No. The wife left.
No. The girlfriend left first.
Mm-hmm. He's nailing. Let's see Nico do this.
Sounds like the girlfriend left first, mm-hmm. and that, I guess, without that third, him and his wife had some issues, and his wife then left, and then he got back together with the girlfriend.
So, you halfway
it's
there.
It's like how do you have so much insight into
That's called
this?
Context listening. You just have to listen to the story.
I don't do that crap.
I love to label it. Context listen. I've never heard of that before in my life. Never done it either.
But is he right?
he's quarter there. So
he's flexing a little bit. He's flexing.
The girlfriend left. COVID happened.
That's what I thought, because you came right before COVID. I was about to ask that.
Well, COVID didn't happen, but, you know, it spread it around. Like, people are like, COVID happened. Like, it was a hurricane or something. So, but, you know, COVID popped off, and she kind of got stuck at work. Like, we was all living together, and she got stuck at her job. And
The girlfriend.
And it was a place where it was a live-in space. So she ended up just staying there, not coming back with the shutdown. You know, it was the 2 weeks. And so she didn't come back. And then she just stayed. Like, I'm leaving. I'm gone. I'm done with that part of my life. Okay, cool. She's gone. So me and my wife try to rekindle. We try to work through our stuff. So we're moving on. We're working through. We're having tons of threesomes. We're having a good time. I'm having a good time. Having a good time. But then it comes to a point where I'm kind of out of that. I just want us to be together.
Stable.
And then I had a bunch of stuff pick up. I went to Europe. My career started picking up a little bit. So I'm getting dates and I'm gone. And
dates for comedy.
Dates for comedy. Okay. Yeah. Okay. No, this is not Bumble dates. This is dates for comedy.
You got back out there after COVID, it sounds like.
Yeah, we in it. So then I leave. I'm on the road for a month. I come back home. And when I come back home, there's a shirtless guy sitting on my couch, right? When I open the door. Shirtless guy sitting on the couch.
Wow. Hey.
So,
hello, my name's Karma. Nice to meet you. Yeah.
I picked somebody else out for our next throuple.
So, well, we done with...
You wouldn't have been cool with that, would you?
Nah, not with another guy. No, with another dude? No, we don't do that at all. That's not how this works.
Not even
a little bit.
Okay. All right, just wondering.
Equality is for suckers.
Exactly. No, I don't want that. That's not happening at all. And if she was into that, I'd be like, well, I'm gone. Well, I'm leaving. You can have whatever you
want. That would have killed it right there.
Yeah, don't like any other man in the house. I like lady maintenance men. That's what I want. I want a lady to come. I told this bro.
But you go in your door, and there's a guy with no shirt sitting on your couch.
Sitting on the couch and watching Power. And this is how I found out Power was a great show.
Your Netflix account.
Yeah. This is how I knew Power was a great show, because I went in and I started packing up and moving my stuff. And I found myself just stopping and watching certain scenes in the middle of moving my stuff
out. I'm done. What? Huh?
I'm like, hold on.
Wait, didn't she steal his truck?
You asked the guy with no shirt. Who's that?
Exactly. I'm like, hey, but what's this mean? Oh, man, he about to get killed.
Go make me a sandwich before you leave.
Wait a minute. So this was your wife's mm-hmm. friend.
This will do it. He lived in the apartments. He had been lurking for a while.
Lurking.
So whatever. She had that happen. That's why I ended up leaving. Well, when I leave, you know, I'm getting myself together. The girlfriend is very poverty stricken. She is, which is what I like. I love women. Well, $150 could change their whole day.
You're right. You know what I mean? No, I get what you're saying.
If you got $150 to $250, you can change a whole woman's day. You know what I mean?
That's a life-changing amount of money for some
of these women. So
Life lessons from Trey Tutson.
For real.
You, El Paso, if y'all know a good PR person, can you please send him up here to the radio
station? I would watch this show. If I had any contacts in Hollywood, I would definitely pitch this show.
But when I was doing all this, I don't want y'all thinking too high. These aren't good women. These are women where if you buy shoes, any shoes that's other than flip-flops, they are mates. They like, oh, this is, thank you. There's actually a soul on this shoe.
Yeah.
You got the projects on lock.
Yeah.
These are Skechers.
Yeah. Best way to pick up these women, drive to a bus stop. You can pick up any woman, especially in Texas, if you got AC. If you got AC in your car and she at the bus stop, you're like, hey, baby, you want to cool off for a little bit? So...
Wow.
So
funny.
So I get there, so he there, and I start packing up and I leave. The meet up with the girlfriend. I said, hey, you need a place. Look here, I'm about to move to New York. I need you to just take care of my space. House sit my place
you till can you
get
live a job. Here.
Till you get on your feet, till everything. I got you. It's gonna cost you. But so she's there and we just kinda started vibing and that was that. And
you
then
started
I,
vibing, but did you go to New York?
I didn't. I lost $25,000 when I was in Europe. I used my card in Poland and it got like swiped, like this thing, it got caught up in the system. And they cleaned me out. Took everything I was supposed to move to New York with. So then that's why I had to stay and I had to kind of start over. And then I ended up finding this other lady. I'm kind of in a similar. She was not. She's actually a very, very successful lady.
Going against the grain on this one.
I dabbled in the Caucasus Mountains. My first time dabbling. And it's amazing. Is real fun. Okay.
Is it your personality? Is it do you know how to bring pleasure to women in ways other men can't? What's the secret?
I don't know. Charles kind of he saw it at Starbucks.
The tripod effect.
That's what he think it is. Which is true. I'm not gonna lie. I think a lot of these women aren't getting pleased as well.
Oh wow.
And I have the time. I'm a comic, so you know what I mean? As long as I could do whatever before showtime.
All right.
So,
Trey's hilarious. I mean, please go see Trey and Charles. Yeah. Is hilarious as well. We got some app chat messages coming in. Marky Mark says, tell Buzz this is great. Haven't stopped laughing since these guys started.
Oh, yeah. Nice. No, we hit the ground running as soon as they came in. That's true.
Leslie says, Charles sounds like Donkey from Shrek.
Oh, that's so racist.
Where are we going, Shrek? I wish I had donkey money. So thank you for the compliment.
So
sure you come to the show and buy a T-shirt from the donkey. Ain't no fun when the rabbit got the gun.
So Charles is a big dude. You must have played some football or something,
oh,
right?
Oh, snap.
Yeah, basketball and track.
Yeah.
I'm actually twice the size that I was. Because I'm 48. So...
You're 48?
I'm 48, so...
Damn!
Yeah. Why y'all say it like that?
I'm kidding.
No, you don't look 48.
I don't.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know. You don't look 48. I thought you were younger than me. I look terrible for my age.
Oh, yeah. He's at least a decade younger than you.
Oh, I'm 35.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Look at him.
Whoo!
Don't say that.
You age like whole food fruit.
Nah, man.
Golly!
Look at that.
Don't laugh at that, Joanna.
But you did play some sports.
Yeah,
right?
I ran track. I almost made it to the Olympics.
Oh yeah,
2000 and 2004.
Wow.
Yeah.
Man.
That's awesome.
That's old school.
What kind of
that kind of size? And you're fast. You ought to be a middle linebacker.
No, I wasn't this big. I was half this. I was like 170 pounds. I was a stick. Right. And yeah, I didn't.
You know what Buzz just found out since the Olympics? That steeplechase is a track event.
Yeah, it always have been.
Did you? Yeah. You've seen people do that? I've seen horses do it before. I never saw people. I've never been to a track in my life where they got a puddle of water in the middle of the track before.
Yeah, but I'm like, I'm at the stage in life where when I listen to Trey, I'm 48. I just got married for the first time. I just got married, and I listen to Trey, and I ain't saying nothing wrong with marriage, but this is the most exciting thing that I done heard since I've been married. It's actually only the second time I've been out of the house since I've been married, so I love what's going on. Right now. Matter of fact, I might not go home.
But you can't imagine ever ever being in the kind of situation Trey was in, right?
No, I thought I had did some hoe stuff, but he took it to a whole nother level. He hoed all the way out. I thought I got all my hoeing out. I ain't never hoed yet, man. He the reason why Santa Claus say ho, ho, ho. Like, that's Trey right there, man.
Nico, did you have calls?
I do have some calls. App chat messages. Padilla says, I feel sorry for the lady that called our show yesterday thanking Buzz for respecting women so much.
I'm just listening to the story, man.
Hold on. I respected these women. I gave them food and shelter. I mean, what else do you want from me, lady?
In Maslow's hierarchy of human needs, I provided all of it.
You two can be like Trey Tutson with $5 and a half a tank of gas.
Yeah, let's get to some of the...
I nurtured those mammals.
Mammals.
Let's get to some of these neckline calls.
What?
Is it playing?
Yeah, man, whenever you're ready.
Oh, man.
People call in and leave messages for us.
Oh, that's great.
All, Nico just has to figure out how to...
Morning, Buzz and Sam. Early Bird here. Yeah, I think Nico's about right on that one. I think if you look back at history, I think the first ladies have gotten more done than the vice president has. What do you guys think about that? All right, guys. Have a good morning.
What? I couldn't understand what he was saying.
He's saying, if you look back in history, that first ladies of presidents have probably done more than the vice presidents.
Oh, that's probably about right.
Yeah. Yeah, probably.
Right. Maybe.
Vice presidents don't do anything. It's like famous.
You ever heard them Nancy Reagan stories?
Nancy Reagan had astrologers up in the White House telling him what time to have a press conference.
Yeah.
Based on the stars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She also had a mouth on her. That's what they said, too. I don't know if you read that.
Look, when Trey says it, it sounds devious.
Yeah, I know she had a certain reputation in Hollywood.
No, that's what I mean.
And Nancy Reagan had a mouth on her.
Apparently... Yeah, listen, I don't want to speak ill of the dead.
Yeah. No, Nancy could have been in my harem for sure.
Oh, wow.
You got another one?
And they'd be like, just say no.
Yeah, you know what? It's hard not sitting where I normally do. So why don't you play them for me? Can you play them?
Well, I don't know which ones to play.
I want to see them fight.
Just wait for a little bit.
We try not to do it in front of guests.
Yes, I would like to make a comment on your Gatorade and wine mixture.
Oh, okay.
In the old country, this is disgusting. We drink wine. We don't drink wine and something else with it. I think in the U.S., you call it a wine cooler, or who is that? It's Mad Dog 2020. This is very bad, mixing wine with Gatorade. It's disgusting. Country. But each to his own. C'est la vie. Bonjour.
Okay.
I hope you don't live close to the station.
I think that was a character.
Yeah, he said the old country. That gave me chills.
Buzz, I got one. Here we go.
All right, go ahead.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Buzz. You want to make the colonoscopy even weirder? And before they knock you out, tell the anesthesiologist to give you a kiss on the forehead.
Buzz is getting a surgical procedure done next week. His first colonoscopy.
Colonoscopy. It's not really surgery.
Right. You got it.
Well, Charles is 48. It's the time for...
Have you got that, Charles, yet?
Would the doctor touch you?
Uh-huh. No. That's what I thought a colonoscopy was. I went into a new doctor. My doctor retired, so I really haven't had a doctor in a couple of years. So I go into this new doctor, and she's like, when did you have your last colonoscopy? Mm-hmm. I said, about 5 years ago. That's not like when the doctor touches you. They knock you all the way under, and they put instruments
up there. Yeah, colonoscopy.
Yeah.
They knock you out.
So you haven't done that, have you?
No.
45.
Neither.
Yeah, 45, man.
And they won't let you do it young. When I turned 30, I tried to go in. You wanted
to do it?
Yeah, because they say with black men that these things show up and you want to try to catch it early. That's why they give you a certain age. So I was like, well, I'll go in at 30.
Wow.
And let's just get out of the way.
Even diseases are racist.
Yeah.
What's the age for white men?
45?
It's 45. Everybody's 45.
It's 45 for all people.
So you're over regardless.
But
you're,
I identify as a redneck, so I
It's Crockett.
Never is when you get your
That's exactly
up.
His thought was, I don't need to go. If I go, they might find something wrong.
Well, that's the point of going.
That's the point of going.
Right. But they make you drink this stuff the day before, and you gotta clear out completely.
No, my dad and my grandfather did, and they talked about how
they said that that's the worst part is the day before, and you just drink this Drano basically that cleans everything out. And I guess if I find out the only reason for that is because the doctor doesn't want to have to deal, it's like, I'll pay extra, man. Just don't make me fast for a day and drink Drano.
So they make you drink some stuff.
Laxatives.
And you're not allowed to eat anything.
Can't eat nothing.
And you
can't drink anything other than water or 7-Up, I think. Yeah. Like I say, I haven't done it yet.
And then they put you under, and then they do...
And then they snake like a Roto-Rooter type thing up you.
Is this a doctor, or are you at Bill Cosby's house? I'm describing something totally different.
All right. Well, this has been great.
Yeah, this is
this
fun.
This has been fantastic. Whatever you guys decide to do, if you do something together, I'm on board.
You on board?
Yeah, I'll write an endorsement. I don't know. I'll do anything I can. Cause
I'm going to get this on video because I don't want to be like, I don't know who the hell that black dude is. He said he endorsed me and Trey Tutson.
Yes.
Hanging out with you guys is like hanging out with Kevin Hart and Charles Barkley.
Oh, that's hilarious.
They got some big old women down there in San Antonio. San Antonio got them big old women at Dirty Little Creek.
Terrible. All right, go out and see Trey Tutson and Charles Allen tonight. There's one show at 8 o'clock, and then tomorrow they've got an early show at 7:30, late one at 10 o'clock,
that's
El
right.
Paso
that's
Comics.
That's right.
Well, guys, great.
Yep. Thank you for
really
having
made
us.
The morning. Thanks for coming in. And enjoy your time in El Paso. Appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Thank
you
very much.
May your life lose. But whatever it get worse, you don't have to live with this anymore. Go check it out now. Just click over to crystalflesh.com.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show, Monday through Friday, 5 to 10. KLEQ and KLEQ HD1, El Paso, a Town Square media station.
All right, into the 8 o'clock hour, we'll be repeating the ghost song of the day, letting you know what, and this is the final one for the entire month of August, but we'll let you know what the song is and what hour of the day to be listening for the ghost song of the day. Call in when you hear the ghost song of the day. Caller 13 is eligible for the grand prize, an autographed guitar signed by Tobias Forge. And you get the daily prize, which is the ghost concert movie soundtrack right here, right now. Guess what? We have traffic again. Let's check it out.
Traffic. With Joanna Barba, only on KLAQ.
Good morning, Joanna.
Good morning. We're still seeing major delays this morning at I-10 East between Artcraft and Red Road due to an accident overnight. Backup extends to Trans Mountain, and traffic is being detoured to South Desert Boulevard, so you'll want to avoid the area if you can and find an alternate route if you're heading in that direction this morning. Again, that's I-10 East at Artcraft and Red Road, but traffic is being detoured to South Desert Boulevard.
This is probably a good time to let you know about the weather. Golfers forecast for your Labor Day weekend brought to you by Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. We have a flood advisory, and we could get some very heavy downfall in the afternoon. Sometime afternoon, maybe 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. They're saying there's going to be some locally heavy rainfall. The latest update, flash flood warning for Northeast El Paso until 11 p.m. So just be aware of that. For the rest of the weekend, things are going to cool off nicely with the clouds and rain possibility, 90 for the high temperature today. And then for Labor Day weekend, highs in the 80s. Boy.
Wow.
That it seems like forever since it's been something other than triple digits.
I think we've hit our monsoon season.
Is that a joke? I mean, it has to be a joke, right?
No.
Sometimes we get heavy rainfall around this time of year, and they call it monsoon season.
Yeah, end of summer, beginning of fall.
But it's not literally a monsoon.
Is it?
I think
for the desert, yeah.
For the desert, maybe. Yeah, so it is maybe. Actually, I don't know.
87 for the high on Saturday, partly cloudy, a little chance of rain every day. Today, the heavy rain and then chances of rain, 15-20% Saturday through Labor Day, mid-80s for high temperatures this weekend.
Ooh, the Southwest U.S. monsoon, sometimes called the North American monsoon, is a seasonal increase in summer rain between June 15th and September 30th.
Yeah, we're right in there then. And this golfer's forecast brought to you by Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. You can set up all your tee times and reservations online at PaintedDunes.com. That's PaintedDunes.com or call the Pro Shop, 915-821-2122 for Painted Dunes Desert Golf Course. Yes!
Yeah.
Here is Nico Ajimian with our top stories of the day. Good morning, Nico.
Good morning, Buzz. Good morning, Joanna.
Good morning.
My face hurts from laughing, smiling. Right. Trey and Charles are so funny. I can't wait to go see them at the club. But we're doing the news. CNN didn't shy away from the questions many have been asking about Vice President Kamala Harris as she runs for president. Harris and her running mate, Minnesota Governor Tim Walz, were interviewed by Dana Bash. During the talk, Bash asked Harris about her policy positions now versus when she was running for president 4 years ago. While Harris supported a ban on fracking as late as 2019, she told Bash that she made it clear on the debate stage in 2020 that she no longer wanted a ban on the process and says she's still open to different things but does not support the idea. When asked what made her change her mind, Harris said that her values have not changed. Harris has also said that her plans for day one of her presidency would be to strengthen the middle class, but gave no details on how she would do that. Here she is talking to Dana Bash.
I will tell you, first and foremost, one of my highest priorities is to do what we can to support and strengthen the middle class.
So what is happening here is that Kamala Harris is running toward the middle. So she's... Now, I would be interested what changed her mind about fracking, because what I know about fracking is it is causing earthquakes in Texas and Oklahoma and places that didn't have earthquakes before.
Well, here's a big issue. Right now, the U.S. is one of the largest oil producers in the world. And a big part of that has been because of our ability to soak up the oil.
It's harder to get, but that's because it's harder to get to the oil. It is a non-renewable resource,
right? What I'm just getting at is that I don't think, as somebody running towards the middle, she wants to give any indication that she would be jeopardizing the U.S.'s prominence in oil production.
Yeah, I guess so.
Or our energy independence. Well, she also said she was open to having a Republican on her cabinet.
That would drive, you know what would drive Trump crazy? First of all, he would be beside himself if he loses the election. Right, He'll never admit that he lost anyway. But if the Secretary of State is Liz Cheney, it's not going to be a MAGA Republican. It's going to be one of these Republicans like me, exiles from the party. Adam Kinzinger, maybe. Somebody like this.
She said, I've got 68 days to go with the election. I'm not going to be putting the cart before the horse. So I guess she's hedging a little bit. She said she was unequivocal and unwavering in her commitment to Israel's defense. And when she had any doubts about how she's or regrets about how she's handled the situation regarding President Joe Biden's ability to run for another term, Harris said, no, not at all. Not at all. Here she is talking about why she may not have achieved all of her policy goals as vice president.
Well, first of all, we had to recover as an economy, and we have done that. I'm very proud of the work that we have done that has brought inflation down to less than 3%. The work that we have done to cap the cost of insulin at $35 a month for seniors.
Here she is talking about how immigration measures take time, but especially since there was a blocked bipartisan bill that Trump had something to do with.
A bill was crafted, which we supported, which I support. And Donald Trump got word of this bill that would have contributed to securing our border. And because he believes that it would not have helped him politically, he told his folks in Congress, don't put it forward. He killed the bill.
And when asked about Trump's derogatory remarks regarding her race and the remarks about BJs in the office,
yeah,
she had this to say.
He suggested that you happened to turn black recently for political purposes, mm-hmm. questioning a core part of your identity.
Yeah.
Any same old tired playbook? Next question, please.
Yeah. Yeah, so while Harris is running toward the middle and softening some of her previous positions to be more in line with the middle, Trump is going extreme. I mean, he's now posting crude sexual, or retruthing, I guess you would say. And I think the more she ignores him like that, he wants to get a response. I think it's even going to get crazier between now and November 5th from his side. So he's running to the extreme edges. The only people cheering him on are the people that are already going to vote for him. I don't know, man. It's a real interesting political season this year.
It's crazy. Crazy.
Unlike any election year that I've experienced. Well, I don't know. 2016 and 20 were pretty crazy, too. But we do live at interesting times.
What does Joanna like to call it? What
the worst possible.
We're in the darkest timeline. Yeah. Well, everything's said to be bigger in Texas, and that apparently includes the fight over guns. Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton filed a lawsuit yesterday against the State Fair of Texas, trying to block the fair's ban on carrying firearms at the fair this year. The ban comes in response to a shooting at last year's fair, but Paxton is calling the ban an illegal restriction on gun owners' rights.
Have you ever been to the Texas State Fair? The fairgrounds are kind of like right in the one of the high crime areas of town.
Well, this is actually going to be interesting because is that land public land or is it private land? Because it's a private event, technically. And
the fair.
The fair. And organizers are saying they have the right to determine whether you are able to have a firearm. And they
said, I didn't know you could. I've been to, a dozen or more Texas state fairs. I've never seen a firearm.
They're
probably concealed, right?
Their reasoning is that other similar events also restrict guns. So they're saying we're not out of line.
You can't take a gun to a football game.
Nope.
Or not high school, college, or pros.
Or music festivals.
I mean, unless you have some enhanced, you're an off-duty police officer or something like that.
Right.
As far as a regular citizen, you can't go to a minor game with a gun. That's what all the metal detectors are for.
Well, the fair reopens in September and will last for almost a month. They say like thousands of people go through there, like hundreds of thousands.
Let's go Sooners!
Oh my God. Oh, that's where they have the B-U-T. Oklahoma versus Texas game, right?
Yeah, it's the Cotton Bowl, man.
Mm. It's been a busy week in space news, and Jeff Bezos has something to contribute. His Blue Origin lifted off yesterday for its 8th crewed suborbital spaceflight. The crew had about 3 minutes of weightlessness and incredible views of the Earth below. Aboard were philanthropist Nicolina Ellerick, Eugene Grin, Vanderbilt University cardiologist Elamin Jagnagir, entrepreneur Ephraim Robin, and UNC senior Carson Kitchen.
Did they have to shell out for that? Were they all rich enough to pay, whatever it's going to be, $1 million probably.
I don't know if they had to. Huh. Well, the entire flight from liftoff to touchdown lasted just over 10 minutes. I wouldn't feel like I got enough out of that. If I just went up to like the edge of space for like a couple seconds and I came back down.
It depends on what the price tag is. Will you get to experience zero gravity?
Would be
a big deal.
Like 3 minutes.
For 3 minutes, you're going to have zero gravity, but you're going to see
the
like
curvature
the entire,
of the Earth.
Okay.
All right. I would rather be like one of those astronauts that are stuck in space. Like you're supposed to go up for one day and then you get like a whole trip.
You would want to be?
Well, if I'm going to pay $1 million, yeah, I'm going to get my money's worth. Leave me in space for as long as possible.
I'm claustrophobic. I wouldn't do well at all. Hey, I got some some college football to talk real quick. The Miners are going to be playing tomorrow, start game time 1 o'clock, and you can hear that game on KLAQ. The Miners, regular season, we're going to have the first three or four games because of conflicts with Chihuahua's baseball, but we're going to have the Miners on in Lincoln against Nebraska tomorrow starting at 1 o'clock. Let's look at some interesting matchups, okay?
All right.
Usually in week one, you've got your football powerhouses playing what I call a sacrificial lamb. You know, it's like number 1 through 5 teams are taking on.
Is Steve coming in today?
Yeah, probably Steve will be coming in. But number 23, USC, is going to be taking on LSU Sunday. This is a good one with a couple of ranked teams. Number 7, Notre Dame at number 20, Texas A&M.
Yeah, Fighting Irish.
Number 14, Clemson versus number 1, Georgia. And then the rest of them are just like, you know, like Nebraska versus UTEP, things like that.
Get ready for the first big weekend of NCAA college football. With tough matchups on Saturday, like number 5, Alabama versus the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers. Plus number 2, the Ohio State up against the Akron Zips. And number 6, Ole Miss hosts the furious Furman Paladins.
Say what?
This weekend, you can bet on exciting football, but ask yourself one question. Will they cover the spread? Check local listings.
The show will be right back after these commercials. Side effects include happiness, laughter, having a great time.
You're in good hands with
every state. Based on the national average annual savings for new home insurance customers surveyed in 2023 who switched to Allstate and reported savings. Savings vary.
Oh, we're back.
Hey. Buzz is back.
Hey, right on, Buzz.
Buzz in the morning show, 95.5 The Q.
I am awake.
Hey, it's Friday.
It's a three-day weekend.
Three-day weekend.
Labor Day weekend is here.
Labor Day weekend.
Oh, there's bound to be traffic, you know, because it's Labor Day weekend and everything. And,
Labor Day is Labor Day.
Labor Day weekend.
Grilling. I'm just waiting for a hot dog.
Summer is officially over.
We're going to take a little family vacation of our own.
Happy Labor Day.
It's showtime.
Money Mo Show. It's Mo. Hello, Buzz. Hello, Mr. Nico and Joanna. And go Miners, baby. Yeah, beat them Huskers this weekend. All right. Go Mo Show. Woo! Okay, bye.
Thank you, Mo. UTEP Miners at University of Nebraska. And that game will be heard exclusively on KLAQ. Starting at 1 o'clock, that game. So check it out. If you're ready to resume news, let's go ahead and do it. Yes! What else is happening?
Well, Richard Simmons' official cause of death has been released. Fitness guru Richard Simmons died from blunt traumatic injuries that he suffered during earlier falls. That's according.
Well, you know, wasn't there a whole thing where people thought he was being abused by his caretakers?
I remember hearing that. So I guess he had fallen previously, and just the accumulation of all the falls is the reason that he died. That's according to the Los Angeles Medical Examiner. The official report released to the public yesterday confirms what the Simmons family told People magazine last week. The 76-year-old was found unresponsive by his housekeeper back in July, and he suffered a fall 2 days earlier, spent the following day in bed. Heart disease was listed as a contributing factor. Over the past decade, Simmons kept in touch with some reporters and fans by phone or email. However, he was rarely seen in person as rumors about his health spread.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. You know, in his heyday, with jazzercise and sweating to the oldies, he was on TV as much as any other person in the 1980s.
I think
he was on TV as much as Reagan.
Like, late-night television show hosts loved him.
Letterman. He always made
Conan.
These super memorable appearances on Letterman.
Because he was just a character, I think.
And I guess, for some reason, Pauly Shore is still determined that he's going to star in a biopic about Richard Simmons, even though he never got the blessing of Richard Simmons or his family. But I guess it's something he really wants to do. I'd say make son-in-law, too.
The Justice Department is slamming the FBI for still failing to properly investigate some suspected child abuse cases and not reporting allegations to state agencies in nearly half of them. The new DOJ report highlighted continuing errors even after the conviction of former USA Gymnastics physician Larry Nassar 3 years ago. Nassar abused more than 100 athletes, including Olympic champion Simone Biles. After hearings on the botched Nassar investigation, the FBI promised it would make reforms. However, it doesn't seem like it. The Senate plans to hold a hearing on the new report very soon. No thoughts on that one? Okay.
Of all the crimes I think you would want to go after and that the public would want you to go after, crimes against children.
Absolutely.
You know, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, the United States Postal Service says it's preparing to ensure a timely delivery of mail-in ballots for the upcoming election. In an update yesterday, the USPS said it will once again implement measures in the weeks leading up to and following the general election to enhance the timely delivery of election mail. Those efforts may include additional pickups, extra deliveries, and plans to speed up the mail sorting process. The Postal Service also said it will avoid changes such as replacing collection boxes or switching collection times to avoid unnecessary optics or perceptional concerns. It noted the 2020 and 2022 elections saw over 99% of mail-in ballots be delivered within 7 days. You know Donald Trump is going to make some hay out of that.
I don't know exactly what he's going to claim, but it'll be something. Even if he wins, you know, it's not enough to win. He's got to claim that he won every state. But if he loses, who knows?
Mail-in. Well, it's going to be Labor Day, and millions of Americans are planning one last summer getaway this weekend. So domestic travel is up 9% from last year, with San Francisco, New York, Boston, Denver, and Chicago among the top destinations. International travel to cities like Paris, Rome, Barcelona, and Dublin is also popular.
I'm sorry, what was that city in Spain?
Barcelona.
Barcelona.
Barcelona. Also, although down 4% from last year, over the weekend, the TSA plans to check a record-breaking 17 million travelers. So be prepared for lines this weekend. God, I would not want to be traveling. Fans of Shohei Ohtani are going wild about a limited edition bobblehead of the Dodgers superstar. The gold bobblehead depicts Ohtani holding his hot dog, Decoy. 40,000.
His hot dog?
Excuse me. His dog. I don't know why I added hot. It's not even in the sentence.
We did this story 2 days ago, too.
Oh, about the bobbleheads?
Yeah. And his dog threw out the first pitch at a baseball game.
Did you know how much the bobbleheads were going to go for? Did we report on that?
They were free, I thought, for the first certain number of people that showed up at the stadium.
Yes, but see, people are reselling those bobbleheads.
Oh, so like on eBay or whatever, how much? I guess they go whatever somebody's willing to pay for them.
$20,000.
No.
Swear to God, the bobbleheads.
For $20,000, you could commission the same company to make an identical bobblehead.
Absolutely.
Right?
For $100, maybe.
Right. You could commission the same company to make the same identical
But it wouldn't be that bobblehead.
Whatever.
A truck crash in Santa Maria, California that caused red peppers to be spilled all over the road has ended up becoming even worse. The truck hit a road sign and there was a ton of beehives on the sign. The bees flew everywhere and a beekeeper had to come collect the hive and insects. What? This was a truck that crashed and it had peppers on it. Have you seen the pictures?
No. It's peppers and it crashed into a sign that was full of bees?
Yes. Nothing seems to be going right for this person. In El Paso news, an infamous El Paso strip club is aiming to reopen.
Naked harem?
Oh my God. Why? That was a brothel. That wasn't a strip club.
You said infamous. Jaguars?
Jaguars.
Jags.
The city of El Paso announced that it is actively pursuing legal action against the owners of Jaguar Strip Club, RCI Holdings, for what it calls ongoing violations of the city's sexually oriented business ordinance.
But they've been shut down for a couple years now, right?
Like a year, right? Well,
they've been closed for a while.
The city's concerns have intensified as RCI Holdings has publicly announced it is soon opening its new business called Chicas Locas in the same building that Jaguar is operated in.
They should call it Chicas Toxicas.
Jaguars, a.k.a. Chicas Locas, made the announcement on Facebook, writing, follow our official page for all the juicy details of our grand opening.
Did you know that that's a chain, Jaguars? I don't know about a chain, but they have one right on the interstate going through Abilene.
Is it a strip club?
Yeah, it's a strip club, and it has the same font on the sign, and it's called Jaguars as well.
This RCI Holdings company must be huge, then.
That may be the only other one, as far as I know, though.
Well, yesterday, a huge operation by El Paso Police, the FBI, and the U.S. Attorney General rounded up 21 gang members.
In El Paso?
In El Paso. In a news conference.
Did Iggy call you to post bail?
Iggy, we love you. I don't know why Buzz would make such a hurtful comment.
Right, that was a very hurtful comment.
What a hurtful.
Iggy is 100% reformed.
He's catching strays. I mean, he's not even on right now.
Right, yeah. But he is going to be on the show tonight at Scenic.
So, he will be. Okay. In a news conference Thursday, U.S. Attorney General for the Western District of Texas, Jaime Esparza, said 21 people with connections to the Chuco Tango gang were arrested in a roundup spanning all of El Paso. Officials said the arrested individuals are suspected of serious drug and firearm offenses. They are charged with possession and intent to distribute cocaine, methamphetamine, and fentanyl. The investigation was led by the DEA, FBI, and ATF, and it started last year in November. After the arrest, FBI officials said they were processed, guess where? Not at the jail, because there were so many of them. The El Paso County Coliseum.
They processed them at the County Coliseum.
Yes. While 21 were arrested, police say 4 fugitives remain at large. They are Jonathan Blanco, Jessica Rodarte, Carlos Flores, and Adriel Belmont. Officials said some of the defendants in the operation were indicted both in federal court and state court. Quote, regarding the charges of those that were apprehended today, several were charged with felony firearm possession. If convicted, they could face up to 20 years in prison or 5 to 40 years in prison. Well, thank God. They're doing their job. Awesome. And 2 heavyweights in the competitive eating world have agreed to the rules of next week's hot dog eating contest.
Mondays. I mean, you say next week, it sounds like it's a week away. It's Labor Day.
It's next. It's literally okay, the definition fine, of next week.
Okay, fine, but it's Monday.
It's Monday. 2 heavyweights in the competitive eating world have agreed to the rules of the hot dog eating contest. Hosted by Netflix at the Luxor Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas, Joey Chestnut and Takaru Kobayashi will face off to see who can eat the most wieners, I mean hot dogs, in 10 minutes. Notably, the competitors won't be allowed to dunk the dogs in water.
That's the Kobayashi maneuver.
Will not be allowed to do that. Or they won't be allowed to separate the meat from the bun and eat them separately.
See, that is like Kobayashi came up with the dunking the bread in water.
Right.
So it kind of dissolves it. And then everybody copied him. I don't think Chestnut did.
Like, if it was just, if you separated the wiener from the bun, you could just let it slide down, that wiener slide down your throat.
Pardon me?
Like, the way that the wiener looks, it would just slide right, like, you could just swallow the wiener.
You might be able to.
No.
I have a gag reflex.
Well, if you're competitive, you must have not trained.
Just like, just put them down there, like.
Train that gag reflex, yeah.
I think you would probably choke. On that, that's, you know, depending on how big the wiener in question is.
That's what they're doing already.
She's on the phone. I was going to say, are you going to jump into this? It's getting really stupid.
It's not. I'm saying that you could, like.
You're talking about. Okay, go ahead. But the wiener belongs between two buns, right?
It does belong, in my preference.
Yeah,
it does.
Right.
With no condom. It's
condiments.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyways, I think this is going to be fun.
Let's end on that. Okay?
Yeah, that's it. That's all I had.
This is Monday. So the backstory is both of these eating competitors. And by the way, can you imagine anything more offensive to like a starving person in Ethiopia than to find out that in America they have contests to see who could eat the most hot dogs, not because they're hungry, but because they have so much food?
That's insane.
Isn't that just nuts?
Sorry, side note. I just saw the messages that just came in. Apparently, Odessa has a Jaguars as well.
Oh, okay. So it is a chain.
I guess so. Yeah. But yeah, that would be super insulting to be promoting. Like, they have Netflix in Africa.
As much as Americans like to bitch and complain, we're a rich enough country that we have eating competitions. Eating competitions.
I mean,
so Kobayashi and Joey Chestnut both were banned by the Nathan's Hot Dog. That's the most famous one on 4th of July, right?
Yep.
Kobayashi accepted an endorsement from a hot dog company other than Nathan's. And I think Chestnut did the same thing.
Right. It's like Ballpark Franks.
But this is going to be Hebrew like National. The Kentucky Derby all day long. They're going to make a special out of this. It's going to be on Netflix exclusively. And then the competition lasts, what, like a minute?
Right.
Or two?
Joanna, you didn't hear us talking about the techniques, but this...
Of the hot dog eating?
Yeah, game? They're not going to allow them to dunk the hot dogs in water.
Oh, dang.
And they're not going to allow them to separate the hot dog from the bun, the wiener from the bun. And I was telling Buzz, that makes sense because, like, you could just swallow a wiener whole.
That's true, yeah.
You might be able to.
No. Some people might not be able to.
If you practice.
But with enough practice,
yeah,
you can.
That's not how you're... digestive, your gullet works.
It's not how the gullet works.
Yeah, that's
gullet. Really. How does the gullet work?
These people have like super gullets. So.
How does the gullet work? You can't just like drop wieners
like a
pelican. You know, like multiple. Maybe somebody could. Like,
with enough practice, you can.
You could double, triple.
They gotta
that.
Get something like 40 wieners down their throat. Your throat's gonna fill up with wieners. Too many wieners.
That's so funny. Wiener, such a funny word.
All right. So here's the trailer for Chestnut versus Kobayashi, unfinished beef.
To be the greatest, it takes a hunger. You understand. On September 2nd, watch the greatest competitive eaters go head-to-head for the first time in 15 years in a rematch where winner takes all. Chestnut versus Kobayashi, Unfinished Beef, live only on Netflix.
This is going to be Labor Day at 1 p.m. El Paso time, and it's going to be coming to us live from the HyperX Arena at the Luxor in Las Vegas.
We just got a message on the neckline about our hot dog.
Well, I've never been so insulted in my entire Christian life as to listen with my two teenagers taking them to Franklin High School to some idiotic conversation about pornography, about an institution as American as apple pie, and that's the hot dog eating contest, and you two of you turned it into
something nasty.
On soul heart, turned it into a disgusting juvenile. I can't go on.
We'll see who can get the most wieners down their throat.
No
Labor Day.
No condom.
No,
Chestnut
mints.
Joey Chestnut.
Kobayashi.
Kobayashi puts it in.
Get ready for dog snog and wiener stuff and bun golf in action.
Most amazing competitive eating contest I have ever seen.
It's unfinished beef.
You saw Kobayashi. Did you see him at all? Did you make eye contact? And what were your thoughts?
Absolutely not. If he was a real man, he'd be on the stage.
Damn. Labor Day.
This Labor Day weekend, get to a sale
at Edge High Mileage on Rollback at Walmart.
Claim based on sequence dyne test under high-low conditions versus API-SP test limits.
Attention station employees. Labor Day is coming up. An appropriate name since you guys will all be working. Thank you.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
The whole hot dog eating contest thing, I was listening to what Nico and Joanna were saying. I mean, I guess in a way that'd be good strategy. You know, just put the wiener in your mouth and let the meat slide down your throat hole. Don't forget to loosen the jaw. All right, you guys have a good one.
That sounds like people are into the Chestnut versus Kobayashi on Labor Day, I guess.
It's a big deal, yeah.
Can you imagine sitting down and watching it? I can't.
I mean, people have done it.
Yeah, but I've never, like, tuned in to see one of them.
What, for, like, the technique or what?
No, it's whoever puts the most away. That's
who can put the most wieners in their mouth.
For what?
Who? For the hot dog eating contest. A caller called in to talk about that.
Nice.
Jenny Robbins is here. Hello, Jenny.
Woo, hey.
Jenny ghosted me when I was in Los Angeles for a week.
No, she didn't. I didn't give her your number.
What?
I forgot.
No. I wanted to hang out. I was so into it.
I hung out with a lot of comics while I was there.
Yeah, I think you hung out with Nick one of the days. And
yeah, Nick Guerra was over at Ricky Skatta's house.
Yes, I heard.
And
I was out at a mansion party that night.
A mansion party? How do you get invited to a mansion party?
You know, just living in L.A., knowing the right people.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Can you tell us whose mansion it was?
No.
You don't know?
It was Henry's mansion. But it was,
like a legit mansion?
I mean,
Or a nice house.
It's like I feel like typical homes in El Paso are considered mansions in LA. But no, it was fancy. It was like they had a catered whole thing. I feel like these people just want to show off money. So
were you someone's plus one?
No.
You just got invited to it and you went to a party.
Just got invited to it. Yeah.
By Henry.
I could have been your plus one.
You could have maybe. Yeah. You could have come out to the.
Her dream is to get into the film business, and she wants to go to school at USC.
Mm-hmm.
She wants to be in filmmaking in some way. I told her to be a critic.
Like you.
A film critic.
Yeah.
Just John Lovitz.
Just of everything.
Yeah, the critic. Because anytime we go see a movie in the theater, before the credits are done rolling, she's already on her phone letterboxing. Do you know what that is?
No.
Yeah. Me neither, but I think it's like a movie review. Mm-hmm. Do you know what Letterboxd is? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can be your own movie reviewer. Yeah.
Yeah, but who's going to listen to what you say?
Oh, your other friends on Letterboxd.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, no. She's going to town as soon as we see a movie, letting everybody know what she thinks of the movie.
Hey, why don't you let everybody know where I'm going to be at for my remote today?
Oh, that's why Jenny's here, too.
Well, that, and then we can talk about the show that we're doing tonight.
I want to talk about that creepy mannequin you brought in, or doll.
Well, but yeah, I
Nico,
just brought it.
Give us the details about the show tonight.
We have a professional comedy show. We're going to be at Scenics Bar and Kitchen. It starts at 9:30. It's a showcase of some of the best stand-up performers from right here in El Paso. It's going to be me hosting, Jenny Robbins, Anthony Austin Brown, Iggy Samaniego, Joe Rodriguez, and Rogelio Avila.
Iggy's not still stuck at the El Paso County Coliseum.
No, he's been processed already.
Processed.
We got him out. We bailed him out.
Chucos Tangos. And I just got an email from Adrian to talk about the Chiba Hut promote.
Oh, too bad. So good.
Yeah. All it's right. delicious. Well, and it's a very important...
Jenny, you're going to be there at 7... what time is it? 9:30
for the comedy tonight show. At Scenix, yes.
$5 cover for the professional show, but then if you come after that, it's free for open mic.
Anybody's welcome to sign up, except Kanye West. He's the only person that's banned. And before that, you get to see just awesome stand-up.
So you can come, you can watch the show and be like, I can do that, and then try
if
to do that
if those people
afterwards.
Can do it, I can do it.
Later today, 2 to 4... Chiba Hut on North Zaragoza. It's their back-to-school event with prizes and giveaways. What kind of prizes are you going to have?
Tickets. I believe we're going to have tickets to Taco Imas. Yes, the festival tomorrow.
Chiba Hut is known for their toasted subs, munchy appetizers, delicious salads, and sweet desserts.
And I will be there from... Do you have the time on there?
Yeah, 2 to 4.
2 to 4. All right.
What are you looking at? If you don't even know what time it is or where it is, what are you even looking at?
Well, you have the full liner. I don't have the liner. But today what they're doing, it is their back to school thing. And today they are taking all school supplies, donations right now. So you can drop off new school supplies at the Sunland or Zaragoza location, like dry erasers, pens, tissues, Lysol wipes, staplers.
Kids been back in school for 3 weeks.
We're halfway to Christmas break already. It's a weed themed place. Of course, they're going to be late on all that stuff. What a wholesome.
Are you just questioning
place.
The entire remote and purpose of their event?
No.
Okay. So go to Chiba Hut, either the west side location or the east side location. Drop off some school supplies if you want to help out. And then tomorrow on Saturday between 4:20 and 7:10, teachers, students, and faculty. Can take advantage of a free toasted sub with a valid ID.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Between 4:20 and 7:10.
Tomorrow, you can get a free Chiba Hut sandwich.
Okay, so however much you might have been led to believe, they do not sell marijuana at Chiba Hut.
Believe me, Buzz has tried.
It's like there's. Like, you know what else is like a weed-themed restaurant?
Which one?
The joint, the pizza joint.
Oh,
or the
joint
pizza. Like, everything about that is, like, 420 friendly, other than actually having it and smoking it or whatever.
They should just go that next step.
Hey, you want to hear a crazy factoid?
Yes.
I have never been inside a Whataburger restaurant in my life.
What?
I've never been inside a Whataburger. I've been through the drive-thru plenty of times, but I've
Whataburger has been inside you plenty of times.
It has.
You're missing out. I think it's one of the things that makes Whataburger nice.
Really?
Yeah, if you need a place to go, you don't want to bring people back to your house at 4 a.m., go to Whataburger and just like hang out.
But why wouldn't you go through the drive-thru?
Like if you want to eat in a restaurant-y experience at 4 a.m.?
I've seen in the window. It doesn't look like there's a whole lot going on in there.
It's the after party. That's where everybody goes for the after party.
Okay. Yeah, and instead of eating in your car or like near somebody's house.
What's with this creepy doll? What are you trying to Annabelle us here?
No, I have it. I'm getting ready for Halloween. I want to turn it into a person. So it's a replica of the poltergeist clown.
Oh, yeah, I see that now.
I want to turn it into a backpack. See if it becomes something.
Are you crafty terrifying. Like that?
I'm kind of. I love Halloween. I'm gonna go to Halloween Horror Nights.
Joanna,
in Universal.
Halloween Horror Nights.
Uh-huh. Horror Nights.
Oh, my bad.
Dummy.
A Jaguar's Halloween Horror Night.
Joanna.
Yes.
You love Halloween.
I do.
Jenny loves Halloween.
Oh my God.
That is terrifying.
That is scary.
Are you scared of clowns, Joanna?
I'm not scared of them.
I don't like
them.
They're
just creepy, okay?
Well,
That one is creepy.
Yeah.
I'm dressing up as
nod
to...
Did you make that or buy that?
So I bought the doll, but I want to try to turn it into a backpack purse. Like just kind of strangling the neck with the arms, you know?
Attempted to open the inside?
You'd wear it to like mansion parties.
Parties. No, actually, no, I'm
it's
going to Halloween.
It's a conversation starter, okay?
I did go to a fancy mansion party for Halloween last year, too.
God.
I went to MG, and then for 420 last year, I went to MGK's birthday party.
Did you meet MGK?
I did, yeah.
Who the hell's MGK?
Machine Gun Kelly.
What?
Rapper dating Megan Fox.
Was Megan Fox there?
She was not, but a giant poster of her was.
Oh, okay. Was MJK What's it?
MGK, Machine Gun Kelly.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he was there. The party ended in him shooting a flamethrower at a police helicopter.
Yeah.
Was he nice?
He was very nice. Yeah, he was nice.
Was Tommy Lee from Motley Crue there?
No, just because he
played him in the movie.
I guess everybody's. Yeah,
so
yeah, he played.
Do you ever get sad after going to all these mansion parties and then going back to your little
yeah.
room at your?
Like I'll go and like house. Have like a whole extravagant like evening and then go like eat ramen the next day, just like.
We were staying in a B&B. I prefer hotel. I'll be honest with you.
It depends on the Airbnb that you get.
It was in East Hollywood. So.
Gay.
Kind of the no, West Hollywood's gay. East Hollywood is homeless and transient. But have right off of Hollywood Boulevard, they have all these houses that were single family residences at one time, and they've broken them all up into Airbnbs. So it's like a house with 16 different Airbnbs. And I guess my daughter's mom went for the cheapest one, and I could not stand all the way up in this
Ooh,
Airbnb.
Yeah, she did.
I'm taller than the ceiling in this place.
You're such a giant of a man.
Well, no wonder you didn't like it. You had a bad Airbnb experience.
Hey, we got a neckline call. Somebody asking about Jenny.
Okay.
Oh, yes, tell me.
I have a mansion.
Would you like to come to my party?
Good morning show. Great Friday, 3-day weekend.
Hey.
I'm calling in because I have a question. Jenny Robbins might be stopping by, and Nico,
Oh, goodness.
Not to throw him under the bus, but I was wondering if you guys could ask her to tell the story that Nico said that she farted really ugly and that she blamed it on the guy and she gaslit him.
Yeah, it was an ex-boyfriend.
Oh, this is a recorded call.
all right, guys, later.
I tried to tell your joke. We had a whole farting discussion the other day, and I tried to tell your
huge farting
your bit about.
So I was dating a guy, and over the pandemic, we were around each other quite a bit. You know, you're in a shared space, mm-hmm. and I called it the one cheek sneak because when I moved in with this dude, that was one of the things my tips my mother had given me as a child. She said if Jenny, you know, if you ever have to fart, if you pull your butt cheeks apart, it doesn't make a noise.
Is that true?
It is.
You got to give it a go, man.
You got to try it out.
You got to do the one cheek sneak, man.
It sounds like a two sneak cheek.
You lift up one cheek, and then you get a nice little.
She's actually practicing right now.
Just a.
Did her leg?
Behind his left, you can see.
You know what? Nice life hack.
Yeah, you know, but see, but here's the thing. So, you can walk away from the and no one ever knows what happened. But there was one time that I let out my and it was silent, but it was also
deadly.
Yep, there we go. And so dude walks into the room. And it was, and we had this moment because I knew it too. You know, when you know that you let out one, it was like a sewer line in the bedroom. dude walks in,
rotten egg salad?
It was. I don't know. I think it was held in farts. It was like, you know, when you're holding in the farts for the relationship,
it was more like a Havarti.
And it all happened. So he walks in, and you can see where it hit him like a wall. Like it
boom.
Just yeah
it's
yeah just
reaction.
right there.
Like he hit a force field.
And then we had that standoff, like that stare into each other's eyes of like, are you going to say something? Are we going to ignore this? Can we ignore this? And then it was so bad. He starts apologizing. He starts, oh, I'm so sorry. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Oh,
it was
God.
So
a gentleman.
Bad that he just, no, he
or
assumed,
that couldn't come from a woman.
Yes,
that
he assumed that it must have come from him because
you
it was
know
so
if you
bad.
Farted or not. Maybe he did fart at the same time.
I think he'd gone to the restroom before that. So he thought that maybe it was like,
and wafted into the room.
Yes.
Don't go in there. That bathroom is closed to the public.
It took a good 5 minutes before it occurred to him, like, wait a second, that wasn't
me.
So, as I said, so after that.
You probably got beeped on that one.
I think so.
Nothing with a word and then hole afterwards.
Oh, right. Okay. All right. So the wind exits was...
The wind sock.
The tailpipe.
Just flapping in the winds. The many winds.
You enjoying this, Joanna?
Listen, guys, I got IBS. It's a...
This is a serious discussion about healthcare, you know, okay?
12 million Americans have irritable bowel syndrome.
Right.
It's not unusual.
It's our food. It's the American diet.
Okay. Let's take a break.
Banana in the tailpipe.
And we'll come back more with Jenny Robbins and her creepy marionette on the way. You could check out Jenny along with Anthony Austin Brown, Iggy Samaniego, Nico and Jimmy. And
the funniest of the whole.
Scenics. And that starts at 9:30.
It does.
And there is a $5 cover for the professional comic show.
There is a $5 cover. Doors open at 8:30, which means that's when I'm going to be start asking for the $5.
It's a steal, I tell you. It's a steal.
Hey, it's Chuck, and tonight on Loudwire Nights, do not miss the pit.
Understanding your knee pain with at thehospitalsofprovidence.com.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show, Monday through Friday, 5 to 10. KLEQ and KLEQ HD1, El Paso, a Town Square media station.
We have a few comments. Some of them have to do with the big Labor Day hot dog eating contest.
Wieners.
Chestnut Kobayashi unfinished beef.
People are saying that our humor is so juvenile. Listen to this new neckline call.
I cannot argue with that.
Hey, guys, it's like middle school humor today, huh? You were talking about eating wieners, and then you moved wieners on to classy ways to fart and poop jokes. What's next, man? Like your mama jokes? Come on. By the way, Nico, your mama's so lazy, she works from home, and she still gets to work late.
Mrs. Ajimian is a wonderful person. Please
don't talk about
Mrs. Ajimian.
You want
like
to
that.
Talk about mothers.
Yeah, I'd like to make a comment about the hot dogs, the wieners. Buzz is right. I tried this when I was in third grade.
This is the method you said they should just put... Let
the wieners slide back down your throat. Yeah.
And I can tell you, you can only put one hot dog down at a time, and it came out. It fired out like a missile. And it has to be masticated, Nico. You can't just swallow them whole unless you have special abilities to do that.
Masticate all the
wieners.
Do
you masticate?
I masticate a lot, yeah.
He masticates and, a lot with wieners.
That fellow that was offended, this bit was the funniest thing you had on this morning. So keep up the good work.
This is real highbrow stuff.
Jenny, how many wieners can you eat?
I feel like that technique of trying to like throw it down the throat, although I imagine you've been practicing quite a bit.
Yeah. We have been practicing.
Oh my goodness. And do you really need to? Isn't that meat already ground up anyway? It's like putting blended meat already.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a good point. It's just like ground up meat inside a casing.
Yeah, it's like half
also
digested
made of
anyway.
Meat, I guess.
Yeah.
I just can't imagine watching this.
Hot dog eating contest. Do you watch the annual Nathan's ones?
No.
Didn't that guy like lose the sponsorship because he went for like a vegan hot dog company?
That's Kobayashi, I believe.
Okay.
And then Joey also was
signed
banned.
A deal with a different hot dog company.
Like
Nathan's
Hebrew National
like,
or something?
This is our thing, man. You can't be our champion if you eat other hot dogs.
Unfinished beef. Feel the heat of the meat.
Hey, so they're going to have a big Kobayashi and that other guy, yeah. Chestnut. You know who should be the master of the ceremonies, right? Haktua girl. You'd have Haktua girl. And maybe they can compare notes. You know, they have a similar set of skills. Maybe she could show them a thing or two.
I'm sorry, Jenny. What was your reaction?
I'm so tired of that. Though I was tired of that girl. That long time ago. Girl. Or just the meat. I remember there was like a while that like every every day I saw something.
Something
with her.
About her out yes. in L.A.?
No, it was just like on social media. There was always just like some, like every day somebody. And there was always some dude like, check this out. Like, and I was like, it was too much.
Oh.
Too much.
I love her little accent, her little Tennessee, like, hey, y'all.
I think guys just got excited over that.
What's up, Moshe? Hope you guys are doing well. The whole hot dog eating contest thing, I was listening to what Nico and Joanna were saying.
Oh, we already played this one. I think we played that one already.
My man, you have got to start following your radio instincts. You've been on the air for over 30 years on those instincts.
Over.
The more you listen to your little comedic voice sitting next to you, the more it's going to take you down the road of like the segment that you had at the end of the 7 o'clock hour. Dude, what was that?
I think he's talking about Trey Tudson and Charles Allen, the two comics who were in
the thruple situation.
Yeah.
Wait,
I don't know. He said that this guy left like 6 messages, okay, about the same thing, that it was just like, I mean, he didn't say it this way, but like it's low-hanging fruit.
What?
Trey talking about his thruple situation.
You think that's what he's referring to?
Yeah. I think so. At the end of the 7 o'clock hour? That was them. That was them, yeah. I don't know. I thought they were really funny.
They're hilarious.
I think a lot of people enjoyed that segment. God, why is everybody telling me how to do my job all of a sudden?
That guy was real passionate about it, too.
What's that about?
Hey, people are asking about the dining deal today and the ghost song of the day.
Oh, crud.
Ghost song.
The ghost song of the day. I should have replayed in the 8 o'clock hour. Dining deal. Let's start with
Don't tell me how to do my job.
Well, Joanna can tell me how to do it. She's my producer. Joanna can tell me how to do my job.
Well, we already did the ghost song of the day today.
Well, we
only
play
the 7 and the 8. When we tell it.
We didn't do it in the 8.
We didn't do it in the 8.
Yes, we did.
No. We did it when Trey and Charles were here. In the
My
7
notes
o'clock.
Say otherwise.
You say we replayed the ghost song of the day. Let's just do it again. All right? Because I'm not sure.
I believe Joanna's notes more than us, so. Maybe.
Just get that ready. I'll tell you about the dining deal. So in less than an hour at 10 o'clock this morning, it's another one of our dining deals. You can get a $50 food certificate, which can also be used for games. You only pay $25 for the $50 certificate. I don't know if you're allowed to get more than one this time.
We'll have to check with Steve on this one.
And it's Oasis Lanes at 1660 North Zaragoza. Now, that's a bowling alley, but they also have a kitchen and a brick oven, and they make this brick oven pizza, and they brought some of it this week. It was good. Also, a full bar, craft beers, spirits, and your favorite cocktails. The $50 certificate, only $25 you pay at 10 o'clock, so about 45 minutes from now, and you do that by going to klaq.com. You can click Dining Deals on the must-read bar, or on the KLAQ mobile app, Dining Deals. So go and do that. So Jenny, you're just in for
the weekend. I was in Atlanta, Georgia a couple days ago. I had a comedy film festival, which, by the way, the film that I had that was at this Georgia Comedy Film Festival won the whole festival.
Were you in it?
Yeah. Of course.
Were you a lead?
Yes. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, it was a short film we submitted, and then
who'd you go with?
A buddy of mine from one of my acting classes decided to make a short film, and we knew I had good comedic timing, put me in, and we took that festival home.
Awesome.
You ever watch a show Barry? Because it's all about acting class.
Barry is.
Can you relate to Barry?
Insanely relatable. Like they did such a good job of all the weird kooky people in those acting classes.
How great is Henry Winkler?
Henry Winkler's great. Yeah. Henry playing the the over the top acting coach.
And Bill Hader, of course, always.
Everything
but the best
Bill
guy
Hader
is
touches.
That Russian guy, Noho Hank. Noho
yes.
Hank.
That guy revived his whole career, or like made a whole career out of that character. Like he had so much notoriety from him. But Yeah, Barry's great. Barry was great. But yeah, I was in Atlanta, and so I decided just to stop by for a couple of days to on my way back. So, you know, El Paso's on the way back to L.A. I'm flying, but I fly too much, Buzz. I fly too much.
You don't like driving?
I don't like driving. But I've got flying down to a science now. I can tell you everything about Southwest, how to get around.
Oh, you know
I
what?
I make little habitats in my little cubby habitats in my space.
This is a big travel weekend, you know.
It is a big travel weekend.
So give me some of your lessons in traveling, okay. Air travel.
So Southwest, way to go, in my opinion. And they also do this like same day standby thing, so you can buy the cheapest flight that day, and you can change it day of. Southwest needs to pay me for this, but this is what I do. So you don't have assigned seats. So I go in. First thing I do is I ask if it's a full flight. If I know it's not a full flight, I go try to find a seat in the back. I take up the whole row, and I'll make a little flying couch back there.
It seems like I haven't been on a flight that wasn't 100% full in 20 years.
Oh, no, I picked the good ones. I picked some good ones. Okay. And even if I don't, then I get the window seat. I take my iPad. I use the flap of my iPad. I smash it in between the tray hole and the chair. Make a little TV in the
corner. Very detailed. Yeah.
Nice. I have little cozy socks. You should say I have a little hood over. It's a whole little Jenny habitat in the plane.
Well, can I tell you what my Southwest move used to be? The row over the wing. So the exit row.
There's
in the
only
middle of the
four
plane.
Of those seats, though.
I know, but if you can get one of them, you got all kinds of extra leg room.
Yeah, if you got long legs, that's the way to go.
You would have to be the first one to get in the plane.
I used to be able to do it.
I
probably haven't flown in a couple of years.
I could take those. I don't, because I know I'm short. So I'm like, I'll leave it for the long leg people.
All right. And your habitat, what was that all about?
She just described it.
Yes.
I thought you meant
I get
like
into my little corner. I have my
gate.
Little pillow. I have cozy wool socks.
Like a blanket fort?
Yes. Yeah. I'm that weirdo. I don't care. I'm comfy and cozy.
Well, what do you think? Southwest just said they're going to get rid of no seats or whatever.
The no assigned
seats.
They're
going to have assigned seats.
They're going to have assigned
seats. Don't love it. My flying couch fantasies are going to go away.
Hey, we have a three-day weekend coming up.
We do.
Now, here's a question somebody asked online, and we have the results. They did a survey and asked people, if your company were to go to a four-day work week, which day of the week would you want to be off?
Wait, we're not a four-day work week?
No. We get about, you know, considering that you're 15 minutes late, it might be more like a a four-day work week for you. Joanna.
Yeah?
Which day would you want off? And I'll see if you pick the most popular one.
Friday.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah.
TGIF.
Yeah.
But Mondays, everybody complains about Mondays. Why wouldn't you take that day
either
off?
Either way, if you choose Monday, Tuesday's going to feel like a Monday.
You're going to start complaining about Tuesdays.
Yeah.
Ugh. Keep the complaining day the same.
Garfield would be like, I hate Tuesdays.
It's great when Thursday feels like a Friday, and then Friday is your day off.
You agree, Nico? Great.
Yes.
So
I agree. Why?
I'm fortunate.
You don't have a 9-to-5 job.
I don't have a 9-to-5, so I kind of pick and choose the days I want to work, and so I
there must
typically
be a certain freedom to that.
It brings me great joy. I've had other jobs and stuff in my life, and this
she gets to go to mansion parties.
I get to go to MGK mansion parties. I intentionally keep Mondays off. Get things done. Run all my errands on Mondays. And
I agree with you. I would take Monday because that's the day that sucks the most.
Yeah, and I just kind of I'll sleep in, run my errands, get caught
Buzz
up for the week.
Complain about Tuesdays.
Ugh, we gotta be Tuesday. Back on Tuesday.
Well, do you want to hear what the survey says?
Sure.
Friday was the most popular option. 47% said they'd like to have Friday off.
Survey says.
And Monday is in second place, but way behind. 27% say they want Monday off. But almost as many, 21%. Picked Wednesdays,
I was talking right in the middle.
You would never have to work more than 2 days in a row if you worked it that way.
You would only throw me off so much.
Would it?
Yes, like just in the middle of the week, no day to work. Ugh, I don't like it.
21%
What are you talking about? It's
Wednesdays.
Awesome.
No, yeah, I'm sure.
I like it. They have a little nappy day, one day to kind of sleep in, reset.
I'm a creature of habit.
The least popular option was Tuesdays. Only 1% of people in this survey said they would take Tuesdays off. Hmm. And Thursdays only got 2%. So
all the days.
Yeah, can we go to the one-day work week?
Well, if you get replaced by AI, you're going to go to the zero-day work week. So be careful what you ask for. We got a big sports weekend. College football fully underway at this point. The Miners tomorrow on KLAQ. And when we come back, we'll talk to Steve Kaplowitz all about
Happy.
It.
Happy
Labor Day weekend.
Enjoy your Labor Day, everyone.
Did you have a nice summer?
My summer was great, actually.
I want a party that makes me feel like I'm flying through the air.
Barbecue, music.
Arcane.
But we just want to party.
Gonna sit down in the kitchen and fix me something good to eat. And make my head a little high, make the whole day complete. Cause we're gonna lay around the shanty mama and put a good buzz on.
Labor Day weekend.
Hooray! Yeah!
We'll pass it to me, baby. We'll pass it to me slow. We'll take time out to smile a little before you let it go. Cause we're gonna lay around the shanty mama and put a good buzz on.
This is gonna be a relaxing weekend.
Most of my weekends could be a Twilight Zone episode.
It's a party, come on.
You're right. We do have to have a party.
Yay!
Holiday weekend.
Yeah! It's the weekend.
Booyah!
Whoa! Friday, heading into the weekend. Labor Day weekend.
Well, I could use a beer.
Me love beer.
We're gonna sit around the kitchen and fix us something good to eat. And make ourselves a little high, make the whole day complete. Cause we're gonna lay around the shanty mama and put a good buzz on. Well, every night and day if I can help it, we're gonna lay around the shanty mama. What a good buzz on.
Party on, dudes!
There's always more. Lemon Park Racetrack and Casino.
Keep it fun. Play responsibly. Need help? Call 1-800-572-1142.
We're in position.
Come on, let's go!
And now, this is going to be good.
Buzz. The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
Partner station 600 ESPN El Paso is Steve Kaplowitz, El Paso Sports Hall of Famer. Do we have is there a media Hall of Fame that I should be entering?
No. No. You know what? But you know what I have suggested, believe it or not? I have suggested this. There should be an El Paso like broadcast Hall of Fame for like radio, TV.
Yeah, I just
and
saw a
like
note.
That.
So
make one.
Our boss, Kevin Vargas. Mm-hmm. Was just inducted into the San Antonio Radio
Hall.
Yeah,
did you see that?
Yes.
Did you even send congratulations to him at all?
I don't respond to that kind of stuff.
In person, you could have said it.
Do you know that I sent him a text and I told him how proud I was?
I sent him a text.
Anytime they put out like an email congratulating somebody for something, come on, man, you're just clogging up everybody's email.
You're such a douche.
You know, Buzz was once a finalist for the Marconi.
Marconi is like
that's the big
Oscars.
One. That's
of
the big
radio.
One. Yeah. What happened? How come you were never a finalist again? Did nobody ever nominate you a second
maybe
time?
Maybe they just quit nominating me. I don't know.
I mean, I'm just saying. And you could probably eventually get like a Lifetime Achievement Award as Marconi, I would think. You've been doing this now 30 plus.
I'd rather have a day off. To be honest,
that 4-day work week. Yeah. Speaking of which,
and we got a lot of people calling about the 4-day work week.
Also,
a lot of opinions.
That caller that you were trying to tell me about, that douchebag is the same guy who called when we talked about farts last week, and he called up saying, "You guys need to talk about the important stuff." Or when I said like we need to talk about politics less, and he was the one that
did you see the call that came in?
Yeah,
from him?
What a
douche.
Do you
want me to play it?
Yes.
Oh, I was trying to save you the.
Oh, I don't care.
The anguish.
Buzz, my brother, you may think that I'm against you or that I'm trying to tell you how to do your job. Already. That is, in fact, not the case. I'm telling you from a listener perspective.
Come in.
Listen to me. Your show has been so productive and so positive for so many years. lately with your Lago City next to you, he's...
My what?
I don't know what a Lago is, but I know he means me.
A lake? Isn't a right. Lago a lake?
Iago?
In a direction that your show doesn't need to go in. you're naturally funny. Everything out of his voice has to be funny. He tries so hard to be funny about everything. With you, it comes naturally. You just got to talk about the important things. Bring up the things that are important to you and the things that matter to you. And if you do that, your show will continue going the road. It has been for the last 30 years. But my point is this. If you keep listening to... you keep listening to him, you're gonna end up on the sideline, and I don't want to see that, my brother. I really don't.
Wow, you're gonna ruin my career.
Yeah, who knew? What a douchebag. Do you know, sir, how many people have messaged us saying that the fart and the wiener conversation was the funniest discussion they've heard?
This guy sounds like he's holding in a fart.
Most of the complaints that I get are that we talk politics too much.
Right.
That's what I thought this call was about.
That we talk too many.
Yeah.
He's the guy that said you need to talk about politics.
Like the comics this morning. The comics I thought were
hilarious. And people were saying that they were just nonstop laughing at those people.
We had a lot of calls of people saying the comics were great. He didn't like the comics.
Sir, I think you are probably on the wrong path of things. And if Buzz listened to you, he would be sidelined. I don't even know what sideline means, but
when he says you're on the sidelines, meaning he'll be off the air.
Off the air, right.
Yeah, he'll be canceled.
Do you want to hear some people talking about 4-day work week?
Sure.
I believe this is Tracy.
Wednesday is the best day to take off. Mm-hmm. You have your real weekend. And then you have a little mini weekend right in the middle of the week. You never go to work more than 2 days in a row.
Yep, that's what I said.
Wednesday is the correct answer. Bye.
Tracy's the greatest.
Wednesday might be, that might be a really good day. If you had if we went to a 4-day work week, which day would you select they let you select?
I'm with Tracy. I like taking a day off right in the middle of the week. Yeah.
But Wednesday?
It's hump day.
But if you put it on Friday or Monday, you could actually go out of town. You can go to Phoenix, someplace within 300-400 miles.
That's true.
You go up to Rodoso. I mean, if you had every Monday or every Friday off, you could get a second place up in Rodoso.
Hmm.
It's cheaper in Cloudcroft, but
so it'd be wouldn't it be a 3-day work? Well, no, 4-day work week. That's right. No, let me think for a second about this.
Let me take a call.
All right.
Joanna said Friday. Nico agreed Friday. I said Monday because everybody, including Garfield, hates Mondays.
How's it going, guys? Talking about the 4-day work week. I currently work 4 days a week, but it's not your traditional schedule. I work from Wednesday to Wednesday. So whenever I come back to work on Wednesday, I work to Saturday. That's 4 days in 1 week. And then Sunday to Wednesday on the next week, that's 4 days too. 10-hour days. And I think it's the best schedule in the world.
Hmm. I would be so confused by that. Wait a minute, is this the week I go in Monday or is this the week I go in Wednesday?
It'd be hard to make plans.
You get a whole 6 days off after your 8 days working for 1 week for the next week. Best schedule in the world. Thanks.
You know, when I worked at the hospital, I think this is pretty normal for most healthcare workers. It's usually a 4-day on and 3-day off. So you would work 4 days and then you'd get like a 3-day weekend pretty much.
Yeah.
And then you go back on sometimes for 3 days and then a 4-day weekend.
Good morning show. I was just hearing about you guys talk about the days off and stuff like that. So I just wanted to let you guys know about my schedule, see what you guys think. I only work 3 days a week. I work Saturday, Sunday, and also on Tuesday. So I have Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday off. What do you guys think about that?
That sounds amazing.
Well, that sounds like a part-time job.
He just wanted to brag, Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, this guy just
isn't
working.
I mean, if you're only working 3 days a week, I can't imagine you're salaried.
Yeah, this guy's probably just broke.
We're getting a lot of nice comments in the app chat. Iris says, keep talking about farts to piss that guy off. That's pretty funny.
But this was different. This was a girl.
talking about it,
giving advice, more or less, about the one cheek sneak. You know, this is knowledge that you can take on with you.
You didn't know about the one cheek sneak until you heard it here.
Oh, and then Derek says that life is too short. We need to laugh at things, which kind of goes on to this other comment from Christian O. He says to that disgruntled caller, Buzz, Joanna, and Nico sure make the Mo Show so fun. Even with the fart wiener jokes, you have to find the kid in you at times. And
we're only talking about wieners because of the Kobayashi versus Chestnut.
Oh, is that finally happening?
Monday.
Oh, they're doing it Monday.
Live from Vegas, 1 o'clock El Paso time on Netflix.
You know, Kobayashi is a huge underdog in this. Huge.
Why? Wait, are you on the betting lines for this? Do you know, like, the...
Nico reported that they're not going to let him do the Kobayashi maneuver.
Dunking the hot dog in water. That would be illegal.
The bun...
Really? You got to eat it with the bun together?
Yes, and you can't take that wiener out from between the two buns.
So this is a first. This is something. So to be honest with you, this is completely different than every hot dog eating contest I've seen in a while. So this one's going to be unique. Because Chestnut, when he was in El Paso on July 4th, ate like 76 hot dogs in 5 minutes.
How'd he do them?
The Kobayashi method.
Everybody adopted the Kobayashi method.
That's correct. So now that he can't Kobayashi it, this could be interesting to see. I've never seen a hot dog contest in recent years, in the last 25 years, where you actually have to eat the hot dog and the bun together and not eat them separately. So this will be fun.
You tune in every year to watch the hot dog eating contest?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Really?
What a loser.
I live for hot dog eating contest.
Yeah, that's the one sport of the year.
10 minutes of my time. Yes. That's all I need.
Do you know if they have betting on this?
They do have betting. I'm sure there's a line on this one.
All right, Kobayashi's going to do 30 wieners.
Yeah, blow it.
I'm a big, stupid jerk. I'm a pain in your ass.
Miners tomorrow.
Jenny can just do that with her hands.
Here it is, by the way, if you're ready. Here are the lines, okay? Joey Chestnut. He's basically a 1 to 10 favorite, meaning you got to bet $10 to win a dollar, okay? Kobayashi is 7 to 2. So that means you can bet $2 to win 7. So Kobayashi is a he's 3.5 to 1, whereas Chestnut is basically 3.5 to 1, a 1 to 10. Does that make sense to you?
Now you could just be spitting out random numbers as far as I'm concerned. None of that makes sense.
Kobayashi is a huge underdog in this one.
Wait
plus
a minute.
Plus 350.
Hold on. I got a live call.
We have a commitment to live call.
Yep.
It's Jennifer. Hello, Jennifer.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
Good morning.
Hey.
Good morning. Well, I was thinking that your D-bag guy actually means Iago, not Lago, because Iago in Othello is the troublemaker.
He's the
Iago.
He's the Jew. Right?
No.
Right. Shylock.
That's a different play. That's Merchant of Venice.
My bad.
What is this about the Jew?
Iago.
Think of it.
He was the guy who hated Othello.
Troublemaker.
Yeah. Mm.
I think he was trying to be cultured and failed.
Okay. I get what you mean now, Jennifer. Yep.
Okay.
Was he saying Iago?
He didn't know what he was talking
like
about.
Okay.
Well, no, but I mean, if you look at it spelled out, a capital I looks like a lowercase L.
Yes. Yeah, that makes sense.
Oh. Yeah, Iago caused a lot of trouble between Othello and Desdemona. You know I was an English major.
Right? I know that you say that. No, you weren't an English major. You were a communications major.
I graduated with the degree in communications. But
and you've been saying you were an English major for years now.
Did you have like a minor in English?
No, it was my major for a while.
You were?
Yeah.
I was an English major. And then I went to UTEP and got an accounting degree and did something useful.
Nice.
But now I can write a kick-off letter to the IRS.
All right. Thanks, Jennifer.
Thanks. Bye.
That's
okay, so yeah, for the longest time, I thought my degree was in English lit, but it was one of those things where you get close and it's your final
year. He would
year
always tell people, like, you know, I was an English major, right? And then that was his line until like
when
last
people
year.
People would try to correct my punctuation and tell me not to indent paragraphs.
What happened? Oh. Yeah, well, that's
you
because
know
yeah,
that you're happened? Not supposed to indent paragraphs anymore.
Why not?
It's for our website. On the website, the indent doesn't show. It just goes back when you publish it. So when he's doing indents, that's completely wasted time.
Oh.
And then I have to go in there and unindent
it's
everything.
It's an automatic response.
I think it just depends on the form, or like where you're posting it to, or what it's.
Just at the end, it was like, I guess, hey, I can get my degree in communications.
What happened? Did you find your degree when you were cleaning up the house?
No, it was at my mom's. And my mom had recently moved after my dad passed.
Right, right.
And my degree was out, and I was like, well, son of a bitch, I was not. I mean, I didn't graduate.
How did you not know? Like, how do you go through your entire time, get a degree, and so then not know what?
My final classes in college, I already had more than one foot in the radio world. So I was just, you know, working a lot and really anxious to just get out of college and get my degree. And, you know, anyway, I totally thought I had an English lit degree.
Well, you were close. But I didn't. Did you keep your degree, by the way? Do you have it? You have your degree, or does your mom still have it?
Yeah, got it. Like in the little leather, booklet that it comes in, or whatever.
Good for you. Hey, Dining Deals goes up on sale in less than 20 minutes.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
People are asking, can you buy two of these?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Yes, you can. All right,
this is Oasis Lanes, which has 40 bowling lanes. And for the 50, you can get two of them, so you can get $100.
That's right.
For only 50, or you can get 50 for 25. And that's good for food, non-alcoholic beverages, or gameplay.
Yeah, let me say
at
this.
Oasis Lanes.
I know it. Now, it doesn't include bowling, and some people are going to say, well, how does it not include bowling? Bowling is, it's $40 an hour to bowl at Oasis. So if we did the bowling, you would have nothing for food. And the whole concept of dining, it's tough. Okay. So we want to do food and games. And because there's so much to do when you get to Oasis, in addition to bowling, that's where Dining Deals comes in. So you can go there, have fun. They have virtual reality. They got the only virtual reality set up in the nation for this particular. It's like a Dutch virtual reality that supposedly is the only one in the U.S. And it's at Oasis Lanes.
Dutch virtual reality.
It's a Dutch oven, and you get in there.
Oh, it's supposed to be like the coolest thing, and nobody else has it but here. You find it in Europe, so that's a really cool.
What is
point.
Dutch virtual reality though?
Like, you gotta go check it out.
Yeah,
I ask for it. They also have arcade games. You get to be the little boy
who sticks his finger in the dam.
Yeah.
Hey, did you ever? Oh, that reminds me. When you were growing up, did you ever have friends that had the little oven that was, what was the oven called?
Easy bake oven.
Did you ever have an easy bake?
I had an easy bake oven.
Did your friends ever have an easy bake? Did you ever went to?
I didn't have any friends that were girls. I was a boy.
No, you played with dolls.
You never had any girls that you played with when you were growing up as a kid?
Yeah, you know, like in the neighborhood, but okay. I wouldn't go over to their house and play with their easy bake oven.
Jenny, you had an easy bake?
Yeah, I did. They were. It was a. I still have it.
Yeah.
I still own it.
Let's do this. Let's take a break and save the sports because you know this is the first big weekend. A lot of teams are going to be playing their first game this weekend.
That's right.
We'll look at some key matchups in week one.
Can't wait.
Like UTEP at Nebraska.
Big one.
Take a break. We'll come back with Cappy. Jenny Robbins is here. You can see Jenny is part of that comedy show tonight at Scenics. Those are the hand farts.
Jenny can do.
That's not a one cheek sneak.
That's my hand.
Like, no, cool. I think she's done a talent show. I asked her to do a talent show once, and that's her talent. Like,
no, one time I got paid $350 for hand farts.
For a hand what?
For hand farts.
Oh, hand for a hand what?
Why does everyone keep listening to that show?
They're juvenile and gross.
That's why I'm saying this show should not be on the air.
This station, its management, and sponsors would like to apologize for the Buzz Adams Morning Show.
How doers get. Limit one per transaction. Exclusions apply. Full eligible tool list in store and online.
Hey, what are your plans for Labor Day weekend?
I'm going to sell adult lemonade. It's just normal lemonade, but I'm going to have a boob out. Boob.
Staycation. I'm inventing barbecued ice cream. Oh, never mind.
I'm going to do a DIY massage, but just the happy ending. Don't look at me.
It's Labor Day. I'm going into labor.
Have a happy Labor Day. Be safe out there.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show is back.
I got a question for you. Let's talk minor football first. I guess a few of the games are going to be on KLAQ. The first three minor games are going to be on KLAQ. So tomorrow, 1 o'clock.
Close.
What time does the...
Jesus.
Well,
it's close. It's 12:30 pregame show, 1:30 kickoff.
Okay. 1:30 kickoff.
So if you said 1 o'clock, they would catch it right in the middle of the pregame show.
You weren't bad.
Minor football.
UTEP named a starting quarterback yesterday.
Oh, who is it?
Skylar Locklear will be the starting quarterback. So, unfortunately, our former intern, Cade McConnell, will not open the season as UTEP's starter. He will be the backup, but Skylar will get his first opportunity, first crack at the Nebraska Cornhuskers tomorrow at 1:30.
You mind taking a question?
Sure.
All right. We've got a sports question for Steve Kaplowitz.
Hi. Good morning show. I have a question for Cappy. Cappy, I've been watching the WNBA since Caitlin Clark started playing. And I was just wondering if you knew, why are the courts different? The men's basketball looks normal, but the women's is like all colorful and stuff. And sometimes they even have like Cheez-Its or something on the court. Do you know why that is? It was kind of distracting at first, but I kind of got used to it now. But I was just wondering, why is it different? Anyway, thanks, guys. Have a great day.
That's a great question.
Do you know what she's talking about?
Yeah, so sometimes the courts will have designs on them. Now, here's what's happened that's so interesting, okay? A lot of these courts are normal courts when you're at the game. But because of TV and graphic technology, they can now project sponsors on the courts and playing surfaces for TV where you wouldn't get it if you're at the game.
You're not seeing it in the stadium?
I'll give you an example. Like, I'll go watch a hockey game, right? And when I go to watch a hockey game, like an NHL game, the ice is normal and the boards are normal. But when you watch the TV version, the boards change advertisements in the middle of the game, and there are logos on the ice of sponsors that are not really there in person. And they'll do that now.
That sounds annoying as hell. That sounds super annoying.
They'll do that with baseball. Sounds like they'll do that with, they'll put a logo on the grass or the dirt. That's,
all digitally.
Exactly. Yes. All digitally.
It's like NASCAR.
Yes. And yes,
as many
right.
ads on your jacket and your car as possible.
Even in basketball, the NBA, they'll have these special games.
Oh,
NBA too now. They're changing the courts of the NBA. It's so weird because she's right. Like, they basically, everybody is now catering towards advertisements, and they can just project it on the court versus actually being at these games where you don't see it. So,
I got a call here. This came in on the VIP line, okay?
Good morning, Buzz and the Mo Show. This is Donald J. Trump calling in. Oh, I have a fart story to share with you guys.
Really?
Yes, you guys, even ex-presidents fart. One time I ate a 50-piece McNugget, and I washed it down with a glass of chocolate milk. Oh, boy, that was a mistake, Buzz. Nothing is worse than McNugget farts with a hint of chocolate. I almost cleared out the entire Trump Tower building. All the alarms started to go off. The entire building thought we were under a chemical attack from holding in their breath. Also, the next...
check that.
Wow.
Wow. Mr. Trump, please.
But you're right. It sounded like he popped out a character there for a moment.
I like it. You're testing Joanna.
I'm telling you, Kamala is starting to get under his skin. So some football matchups this weekend. There are some top 20 teams playing top 20 teams.
Yeah, there are. There's actually a couple.
You got Notre Dame and Texas A&M.
That's a big one.
That's going to be a big one.
Who
that's
are you liking
one
that one,
watching.
By the way?
Notre Dame.
I mean, I don't know anything about the programs this year. I'm just not that in deep with it, so I'll go for A&M.
All right, I went with Notre Dame.
Well,
but that's
they're
good,
in Texas,
that's a good,
so I'm just
pick.
Going with them because they're in Texas.
USC LSU Sunday is going to be a big one. That's a 5:30 game. It's going to be on ABC. That's two top 25 teams. Last night we had a couple of great games. Colorado almost blew it at home to North Dakota State.
North Dakota State almost knocked off Deion Sanders. Deion Sanders, they were showing his press conference on TV. He is sporting a white beard. I mean, it is snow white.
Grandpa,
whiter than Fred Sanford's beard.
Justin was saying he's going to a game for Texas Tech versus what's the team that
Colorado
Prime? Yeah,
that's
just to see
one.
That.
All right. By the way, last night best game of the night was Minnesota and North Carolina. North Carolina won 19-17, but it was a great game.
All right, that sounds like a close one.
It was a fun game.
All right, not all the matchups are going to be that awesome. However,
get ready for the first big weekend of NCAA college football with tough matchups on Saturday, like Number 5, Alabama versus the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers. Plus, number 2, the Ohio State up against the Akron Zips. And number 6, Ole Miss hosts the furious Furman Paladins.
Say what?
This weekend, you can bet on exciting football, but ask yourself one question. Will they cover the spread? Check local listings.
Well, that's it. Show's over.
What? We just started.
Yeah, well, the show's over.
That's the end.
That's not the end.
Why, yes, it is.
Right. That's the end.
And that's the end.
That's the end.
The Buzz Adams Morning Show will be back Monday morning.
Hello, everybody.